How did your dog taste one?
For real.
We're dying to know.
Did it taste cosmic?
What?
We were making fun that you were taking
so fucking
too
long that you cooked Astro.
It had to be, bro.
He was just I know a guy.
He was pissed, bro.
I know a guy.
What's the best way to subdue the dog?
I know 1.2 billion guys.
Yeah, you drop it in hot water and all the hair falls out.
You drop it in hot water. You don't kill it first, you just shave it. Yeah.
Bro, you kill the lobster before you kill it. You don't kill the lobster, you let the water boil that bitch. Oh fuck, I died.
God damn.
God.
Mm-hmm.
God. For real? Let me cook my dog. Fuck, man. I gotta stop talking. I can get karma.
Karma? How does that even work, bro? Oh, you're gonna wake up and it's gonna
he's
be
gonna
in
go
the
to a
suit.
Restaurant and he's gonna be fucking
it's gonna be in a pot.
Rat.
No, I've had a rat.
What? Jealous, bro. How does it taste?
Everything tastes like chicken to me. I don't actually know.
There's no way everybody tastes like chicken.
No. Arguably the worst person to ask in the Discord.
Yeah, I don't know what it tastes like. But I've had alligator and crocodile
and
rat.
It tastes like chicken.
I'll take the pasta.
Dang. That's the worst kind of not racist to be. Food not racist.
Actually asking the arguably the worst person.
All right,
I'm saying rabbit as steer, bro.
If you had to eat one of us to survive, and you're going off of,
let's
say you're going
of
off of taste, you're going off of taste, Juan. Who are you eating in this Discord?
Which
you have to
one
eat a person.
You taste the best.
Yeah, basically, off of your
whose meat is the best, bro?
Yeah, who's got the best schmeat? No, you have to do it. You're gonna
you
die.
Had
if you
to taste the meat.
Yeah, we've all answered the question. Yeah. It's your turn.
No, it's against the law to die. No, it's a you go to hell if you die like that.
I'm already going to hell.
bro, I already told you, bro. You're not going anymore. The Pope said you're chill. You're big
chilling. Yeah, but the Pope still doesn't like premarital sex.
Oh my God, bro! Can
you're
you
listening
pick
to
one?
The guy that touches children?
Yeah, dude. Besides, it's only
no
sex if it's
way.
Between a guy
no
and a girl.
No way, you're also having premarital sex. I thought you were only one sinner.
What would that be?
I believe in sin, but only one type.
That's not true.
That's sin.
Oh.
Oh.
Wait, how did this one?
All right. If you're not gonna choose, we're gonna choose for you.
I'm
everybody
a
gets
boy,
one vote for somebody sin. Other themselves, of who Juan will eat.
Juan.
Hey, yo. No.
I'm voting Jaden.
Nice.
Bro, are you really thinking? Even think about it, like, damn, bro, which one would I?
Dude, I'd make a good rotisserie chicken, something. Bro. Yeah. I'd be a good rotisserie, bro. Yeah. I ain't gonna fry it.
How's the person justify it? Is it like, why would you eat me or why wouldn't you eat me?
Oh my
I haven't
God,
done
my
double
bro,
that's what I'm doing.
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
You gotta rest.
I haven't started it right there, and D&D started 5 minutes ago.
Mm-hmm. You know, we're all here.
If you had to eat one of us, which one would you eat?
Based
on
my camera works down.
Hey, let's go. Very nice.
Is this for eating somebody for sustenance?
No, this is. You want the best flavor. You're trying to do a ratatouille here.
Okay.
Like Hannibal Lecter.
What
was the option? Anybody in this call?
Oh.
Anyone can get it.
Yeah, anyone can have their shmeat eaten.
I thought you were talking about like eating between rats or chickens.
No. We're talking about eating people, but only like the people in this call.
Yeah, you picked the rat, right?
What? The rat?
We got a rat?
Is Jaden the rat?
I'm a rat.
I'm talking about between rats and chickens.
A rat or a chicken? Which one are you? Oh my God.
Do we have everyone?
I know, right?
Ready to go.
Sent them to the afterlife.
What the... This doesn't even look like League of Legends, bro. It's like,
dude, that's Yadas. Crazy.
I might get up a lot though, Whitey, because we're packing to go to a trip tomorrow, and I packed like everything yesterday.
You're
but
packing?
I'm sure something's gonna happen.
Dude, it sounds like we're eating Steven. Oh my God.
Yeah, for real.
Because I'm.
Sounds like he already made his decision. He's leaving the country.
That's what
bro.
Makes you guys choose a person to
him off the island, bro.
He's trying to get out the country now. It's too late. Oh my God.
dude.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Pop.
How long have we been in here for? It's supposed to start 9 minutes ago, and Anthony started a game at 7 on the dot.
I know, for real. He didn't want to. He didn't want to play a regular league game.
That's actually insane.
Yeah.
Are we ready?
I already. Yeah, we're always game, ready.
No, we're actually not. We're quite the opposite.
That's what you think, because you're never ready.
I think we're all here.
Oh, okay, bro.
We're all here. Yeah, I got good sleep. Fucking.
I got good sleep, so we ain't passing out.
Yeah. Right.
I swear I did.
Over under, boys. Hey, place your bets.
Good night rest.
All good.
No way my team is doing this to me. Mm-hmm. So why can't I flash in this bush?
Oh, right, God. Right. Well, you got people
here.
Oh,
my God. It's another champion.
I think most people are ready. I'll just start with the recap because we'll just jump on in, and then you all can continue what you were doing because we were in a hectic start anyway in turn order. So
you want to message Xander that you're going to do the recap so that he can actually listen?
Yes, whatever. He wants to be there for it. He was also here last session.
Right.
If not, I can give him the lowdown. Extra slow version. But not a problem. So, recapping where we began last session. Last session, you all had began your journey by heading back to your ship after gathering an important ally in the Juggler. You spoke to the ex-king, Kalar, confirming your journey and asking him for anything to know about Ozamata. You all then went to the Rock Rat using the back door entrance and speaking with him, finding him in his lion's den underneath the Rock Rat. After introducing each other and feeling it out, you proposed him helping you in your revolution to put King Kalar back up as the true king. When he had asked for his own kingdom and reign on the rock, Flint trying to cast a spell magic to show their power and persuasion had no avail. You had left Ozamata feeling confident. Having met somewhere in the middle after their further negotiations, you all had promised him immunity when King Kalar was back on the stage, along with his employees as such. You then, after that, began to investigate the other Ozamata lead, who was actually a fluke trying to scam you for money on the second floor of the Rock Rat. After quickly venturing through there, you all wanted to go to Gerald Fizzy Pants, trying to further discuss and meet other people. And on your journey there across the rock, you had been stopped by a checkpoint, an intersection just crossing over into the middle city. Shadow snooping around at the intersection found the guards there to be much more equipped than their standard town guard, and he also saw an invisible horror that was watching you all. After Jadedon and Flint went up to the guards and were noticed by their captain, you all began to flee, causing havoc and chaos around you to try and get away. The guards and the invisible creature gave chase, and that is where we left off, as you all were in the midst of trying to escape. We went through a turn order. We're back at the top. We are at the lovely little crappy drawing I have here.
I don't even remember the turn order.
Let me see if I can pull it up. I have it.
I think it was saved.
Yeah, it's just saved. So here it is.
Jaden was first?
Jaden actually rolled crazy.
Yeah, I rolled like crazy. The hell?
Mm-hmm.
It's crazy.
Yeah, and so the way that I have my lovely little crap drawing spaced out, you, P, the party, are currently two steps away from them, the guards. If you guys make it to the outside, if you guys make it all the way to the outside, you will have escaped and have made it, losing the tracks. If they catch up to you, pulling you closer together on top of each other, at that point, you will begin combat in the streets of the Rock Brawl, as they have made way to engage you sufficiently. But for now, you are at a safe and healthy distance, but not escaped. We'll begin back at Jadedon, as you all are in the midst of your running through the streets, dodging down alleyways, you know, moving across, causing chaos by having civilians, you know, using precipitation, and you convince people to start attacking the guards and otherwise what you've done so far. How would you like to begin to continue your escapade of leaving?
I got nothing else to do, so I'm just going to keep dashing away from them.
All right.
I got nothing else to stop them. Good luck, guys.
Sounds like you are just using your pure speed against theirs.
Yo.
Feel free to give me a athletics roll and using your strength to out of your legs to carry you further.
Get this other window open. There we go. Athletics, please. Oh, okay. I'm on all fours. All
right. 24. They're going to try to oppose with their own. So let me have to go grab their character.
Crazy ass roll. I'm going to turn my fan on.
Very good. Let's see. Where did I have? Oh, yeah. Of course. Let me pull up the sheet. All right. Not so proficient in athletics. Yeah, they have no extra bonuses. So it'll just be a strength roll. Which he severely fails as he tries to use his strength to push ahead. You just keep pacing past them incredibly fast.
This guy stinks.
Got the zoomies.
Mm-hmm.
Your eyes are wide. Your pupils are dilated.
Yeah, all fours.
You've made another space in. Away. The guards are going to try and do their best. You see. Let's see. Yeah, as they all, you know, see them beginning to catch around, they're looking. You see the guard use his superior perception and charisma to try and guard them. He say, you, this way, that way. You see them all split up down alleyways as they spread up from their group of 8, 12. Into smaller groups as they distribute themselves. I could have everyone in the party make a stealth check.
Are we all like, is there any one of us that's already safe somewhere? Like is like hiding somewhere? Or are we all still just running?
I assumed you were all together. I know, I think Erlinda tried to disguise himself and hide. In the group, and then they had saw him, but I don't think anyone else had like made a point to like leave the party to hide themselves away.
Gotcha.
All right. So this will be on his perception to try and beat over half of you. Surprisingly, it's just the straight wisdom. Oof.
Oh my gosh.
He did very well as they. You know, quickly have spread out the tactics and the perceptions of, you know, this general has gave them the upper hand in getting closer to you. You guys go to turn down an alleyway to sprint through it. You see several guards sitting at the end of there, kind of closing in on you. They've made their step back. From there, we jump to Ireland. How would you like to escape?
We went backwards on the, okay, I see it.
Yeah, so it's like they are always them because they're chasing after you. It's how far will you get away from them.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So
I might have to take one out of his book. No. Let me see. I tried disguising it, it didn't work. I will do it. Expeditious retreat. And run.
Alright. Both actually each of their turns you can take the dash action. Alright. So you are just moving faster than now. So I say, you know, burning the spell slot. I mean, you are faster than them now with just even their you know, pure speed. There's no way they can overcome that. So you all will gain an advantage as you begin outpacing them even faster. Flint.
So we're all. Like grouped up then, right? Like my question is, am I next to Shadow?
You could definitely like quickly like, you know, go over to Shadow amongst your scurrying away.
Okay, so like while we're running and stuff, because I don't really have much much more that I think I can do. I already like incited mass panic, so I'm gonna run up to Shadow and I'm gonna jump into his arms, like you know when you carry someone that just got married or something. And as I'm jumping into his arms, I want to say to him, like, you're a lot faster than me, so I'm gonna just leave this one to you. And as I'm jumping into his arms, I'm gonna like go into like the ball, like into the orb that I carry, just like teleport into it and have him just run with me because I'm not as fast as him.
All right.
So I'll leave it at that.
All right, I like it. In your jumping into the ball, I'll say this would be kind of a similar thing. Feel free to give me a sleight of hand, stealth, or like arcana check.
So my choice?
Yeah, you can choose either of those.
Okay.
Whatever you think. Because in my eyes, right, you see, like, you guys are running the group and the commander, the guards that are chasing you are trying to track all of you down, make sure no one escapes. So you disappear into this ball, and he's like, wait, one's missing. You know, checking the crowd, make sure he didn't, like, disappear into the rooftop or anything. You have distracted him in trying to track all of you. So this is, okay, like, your attempt at confusing them by disappearing from the group.
Okay, I'm going to do Arcana then.
All right. This will just be his perception.
You tell me this guy rolls like insane again.
He does not roll better than you. And amongst his confusion, he takes a few steps, stutters, and says, wait, I swear there was another one. And you guys have now significantly outpaced them, one step away from disappearing into the crowd.
I got you, Flint. I put the ball in my pouch.
All righty.
Thank you.
Hiding safely in the ball.
Or in my cloak, rather.
All right. In the cloak. Which, no, but funny enough, we moved to the cloak.
Oh, my God.
Does it... Are we any real distance away from them? Like, measurably?
I would say you're probably at this one. I'm assuming it's like 60 feet maybe per. So you guys are like almost 180 feet out.
Okay. Well, my idea isn't going to work that way I wanted it to. Damn. So, if I use mirror image, can I have the mirrored images move in different directions? Or it just copies exactly what I'm doing?
It depends on the spell that you're having. It depends on like the level and like what it is. So, is it mirror image is like the exact spell?
Yeah.
If you can put the thing in chat, that'll help me see exactly what the thing. So usually it'll say exactly. Okay, so yeah, mirror image is a little different. So mirror image is like they are exactly on you. It's kind of like the if you're looking at somebody and you see like three of them, like in you, two to the left and right, because you're like really a little tipsy or something like that. This is kind of what that's describing. It's not like a minor image, which is like you display yourself somewhere else.
Okay. So using and how many of us there? It means all of us, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is everyone.
All right, so I'm gonna put two hands on our slowest people.
Okay.
And I'm going to cast Invisibility.
Very nice.
At the fourth level. So right. I can make myself invisible and two other people invisible.
Oh, yeah. No, Jesus. That's pretty good. Yeah, so with your invisibility for up to an hour, who's the other person you touch then?
Who is the two slowest amongst us?
No, I'm in the ball right now.
Probably not the Tabaxi. So probably not Shadow.
Slow as fuck.
Has to be Yume, right?
Yume is really slow.
Or Samael. I mean, Erlen could be. Well, Erlen has expeditions to treat.
I think Yume and Samael would be my targets because everyone else has got something else going on.
Okay, you make the two of them invisible. All right.
And myself.
That'll be a. Is that? It is a fourth level. That'll be three targets.
Yeah.
So,
do we ever discuss where we're rendezvousing after running?
You guys are like in a group enough right now. It's not like you all split up into multiple directions. I think you kind of all mostly stuck together. And so that's why I imagine it, at least, as you all have taken your paces. So, yeah, but with Cloak, you know, just, you know, causing you all to go invisible, at least the three of you, you quickly distract the guards enough with this powerful spell to make them lose trace. The three of you invisible, they've lost track. The ones that split up have gotten lost. They're trying to go back to Commander. We lost. We don't know where they're going. And you all have successfully evaded their eyes. So we can jump out of turn order.
Grats.
It's too easy.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't even have to go invisible there. I mean, go ghost.
Going back up to the top world here. During the chase, you guys were making a good distance. You were around here, so...
Probably... we were like right in the market, or like, weren't we? We were like here. Yeah. I think.
So I'll assume you guys are like, somewhere around here right now. Just to put you guys at a pace. Yeah, the place that you were found out at was down here. So you guys have made your way around. As you guys kind of take a breath and catch yourself, you notice that the guards that seem to have given chase or stopped as they kind of retreated back. But yeah, you're about, just about 600 feet or so from where you originally were. But you all collected yourself now amongst the streets, alleyways, hidden in the edges of the low city, and found yourself some time to a quick reprieve.
I'm in a ball.
Oof, we barely got out. Nah, not really.
I was never worried.
Well, they're definitely...
I stopped concentrating on invisibility, so now we're all visible again.
As I hear them talking now, I come out of the ball.
Yeah, I give you a little knock on the ball.
It's God, that sounded horrible.
Yeah.
It's like a fish in a bowl.
Yeah, I'm tapping it.
All
right, you can come out now. I think we're okay.
Don't ever do that again.
Yeah.
Don't knock on it. Wait, what? Just tell me.
I think we might need to find a stealthy way to get into the arena, because I don't think they're going to let us just willingly go in. And we still need to sign up.
Yeah, I think...
Go ahead.
No, it's fine.
No, I was just going to say, I honestly didn't even think they were going to start looking for us already like that. But
it's not just us. They were separating other people, too. Maybe they're just trying to curate who gets into this event. Maybe it's not even worth fighting in. I think it could just be all one big setup.
I think we should still fight in it, but I don't know.
Maybe, but whatever that monster was that was behind the guards that you guys couldn't see or didn't notice looked terrifying. I'm not even sure what it was. I don't know a whole lot about those things. This kind of gave me the chills, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I didn't really notice
it. We fought some pretty scary things before.
Just to give you all a reminder of what it was.
Oh, that looks horrible.
Yeah. I don't know. We've definitely fought some scary stuff, Erlen. But I don't know. This felt different.
Sorry, that thing didn't look all that tough.
You have another voice now.
My other hands went invisible, so they kind of,
You know.
Gotta use a separate pair of hands if you guys want to talk to me.
Wait, I'm confused. Your hands are invisible or you're invisible?
Huh? My hands were invisible.
Okay.
His only hands.
Okay. I think I understand. But yeah, I don't know. If we like go back on the whole plan now, we gotta talk to everybody again, and I don't really want to do that. I want to go see the Colosseum.
Hello, the king is alive without that plan. Without the king just straight up dying, the murking him.
Yeah, we should find. Well,
I mean, I guess it's all about finding a way in, then, right? I know.
It can't hurt to scout the area.
We also came out. We have to sign up still. We haven't even signed up.
Yeah, I think. I don't know. If we wanted to scout, I could have Cruel go invisible and just fly all the way over there, and then we'll see what he sees, and that could be like the easiest option. But we might not get as much information as if all of us try going.
Too big of a crowd would draw too much attention.
So we split up, or do we just wait here?
Maybe just a few of us go, or maybe Cruel can just sneak in and put our names on it without them even noticing.
I don't know if they're going to let just this, like, imp thing fill out. Sign up.
I volunteer.
I volunteer on my own.
I think what we need is a distraction and an invisible guy.
Okay.
Well, can you make people invisible again?
Not anymore.
So, great suggestion. Thanks.
I'm glad you can go invisible.
I can't go invisible. I'm still visible.
Do we know if you just gotta, like, put a name on the thing, or if you have to talk to somebody? Because we could just... Do we have, like, disguise magic, so we could just change our appearance?
Mm-hmm. That's what I was thinking we could do. I have a potion of disguise, so...
Do we even need to physically
be at the arena? Can somebody sign up on our behalf?
Oh, that's a good one.
That's good thinking, Jadon.
Glad to see there's something in that big lion head of yours.
I've been doing a lot of thinking.
Have you?
Yeah. I've been solving 95% of our puzzles. Killing 100% of our bosses.
I need a reminder. Is this Colosseum bracketed like a tournament?
We have no
idea. We don't know.
We have not checked it out.
Negative idea.
Yeah, we don't know the format.
I have a plan.
Yume's doing something.
Oh!
Yume's cooking.
She's shutting me up.
They have two.
Oh, you can make two things visible. I have an idea. If we can sign up for other people, why don't we just put a bunch of fake people and mess with the order of the brackets?
We don't know if there's brackets or not.
Just in case.
What advantage does that give us?
Would we also have to pay the entrance fee for all those people?
Oh my god, there's probably an entrance fee.
I had not considered that.
You know what?
You know, I liked when he talked less. I'm going to be honest.
Different personalities for different sets of hands, bro. You just gotta get used to it.
This one's a talkative hand. Are your hands like the things from Smash where there's like the crazy hand and then there's the like chill master hand?
You can think of it that way.
That's funny. What does this hand look like? What's the cowboy hand look like? Is he always doing finger guns?
Yeah, it looks like it just moves around like master hand would.
It has a 10-gallon hat on.
Oh my god.
It's got like a miniature 10-gallon hat on like the middle knuckle.
Mm-hmm.
That's funny. Yeah, Yume could make two of us invisible, and I can send Cruel with that group of invisible people, and then those people can sign us up and scout.
And Erlen, being the sweet talker that he is, can go talk to the people up front so as to not draw attention elsewhere.
It has to be Yume and one other person. It can't be... They have to do it on themselves and one other person.
That's a great idea. Someone of that level of intellect would be perfect for this type of mission.
If it says you or a creature.
Yeah, I think you could do it on two people of your choice. Like, you don't have to do it on yourself.
Yeah, he doesn't have to do it on himself.
Unless he wants to go.
Yeah, but also, one thing, it is concentration. So... You can't cast it again because you'll break the first one.
Oh, there it is.
So he's only got one person.
Technically it is only one, because unless you're like have a potion or like a spell scroll or something, because the concentration, you can't like overlap two concentrations, unfortunately.
DL's pissed.
Yeah, it does suck.
Well, I feel like Shadow could go with somebody because Shadow doesn't even need to turn himself invisible to be really sneaky. And the other person, oh yeah, the invisibility only lasts 1 minute. Yeah, that's not enough time.
How come greater invisibility lasts less time than regular invisibility?
Yeah, I think greater invisibility is something you want to use when you're fighting because it's not going to turn off when you attack things. So you can just keep staying invisible.
Oh,
but then that makes it really
strong. But I don't think
that's why it's like for a minute.
Shouldn't we just use the minute just to get around that little guarded area, just to get on a better route to the arena?
Well, what if we get past that and then there's another blockade or something? I think we can send two people probably. Like we send Shadow and somebody that's either disguised.
We can probably send three people because I can go ghost and sneak around that way. So two people invisible and then me.
I can always be someone completely different. I can change my entire being. I can be a walrus again.
I also have the potion if someone wants to take it. And I'll send Cruel with the person.
To help give some context to the feelings as you've walked around, up until when you left the Rock Rat in the Northwest, until you got to this point, there wasn't another like blockade or intersection or anyone else. So you traveled through most of the entire Low City without seeing anyone else. It was only at that point when you got to the crossing point between the Low City and the Middle City where you had seen that, you know, intersection, blockade, checkpoint. So a majority of the city so far that you've traveled through is open.
Okay, let's make a choice. Who's going? Who wants to go? I'm sending Cruel.
Where are we going?
To sign up or try.
I'll go.
Okay, do you want to disguise yourself? I have a potion.
I recommend you disguise yourself because if you get caught, we can't
say.
Don't
they know exactly what all of us look like?
I think so. So you want the potion to hold it out to you? All right, take it. I want to get rid of this thing already. I've had it since the beginning of the campaign. You have a potion of disguise self. So let me search up that spell because I want to see how long it lasts.
Probably an hour. Maybe 8.
It lasts for an hour. Yeah, it's what Anthony put.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever you take it, just make sure you get there within the hour. Okay, so we have Samael. I think Shadow should go, but it's really up to him because he's pretty stealthy. I'll send Cruel with the group. And I don't have a way to disguise myself. I can only change my clothes.
I actually can't go today. I'm out of spell slots running away.
Me too.
Wait, hold up. Never mind. I'm fine. You can use higher level spell slots to cast lower level spells, right?
Yep.
Even if they can't. Okay. I can go if we want. I can alter myself.
Okay, so how about... about the three of you and Cruel go, and then the rest of us go talk to the king about what we didn't tell the king about the new deal we made, right?
You had not talked to Ozamata yet, or King Kalar, since you talked to Ozamata.
Yeah, we should go tell him about that stuff. And
but isn't the king gonna want to hear it from Erlen? Or does that not matter?
I don't know.
He's cool. He my second hand man over there, Flint, should be able to relay.
You guys can also if you have the time, you can go give the auto gnome guy his stuff back or something. And do you guys have money to sign up if in case it requires money to sign up?
Check. I have 40 platinum.
Well, that's the thing, Erland. You go to check in your pouches where you normally carry all your gold. You say it. What? No, I swear I must have placed it in this one. You look and the pouch is gone. You're like, no, maybe I put it in my other bag. You look in there. You cannot find any of the gold or money that you had on
where
you.
Where did I feel the person? I look around. Guys, check your pockets.
Check. All of us? I start checking my pocket.
I will also start checking mine. Also
checking my pockets.
The rest of you find everything you had before.
Oh, okay. I'm good.
Okay, we lost about...
We?
40... Well, yes, we pull our funds half the time. 40 platinum, 60 gold.
At what point did you let someone touch you that happened?
I don't...
Damn.
You can make an intelligence check if you want. You recant. Or if you can think of times.
Yeah, I'm trying to think back on one. Just straight intelligence.
Mm-hmm.
When I might have had an altercation or bumped with someone. Oh, yeah, no.
I can't remember. It's a hazy day.
I think they
the fog
whitewashed me.
It won't clear.
Where was I the last day? I'm just...
It is a blur. You've done a lot in the last 24 hours. The juggler, the inns running around, the chase just there. Could have fallen off. You don't remember.
And anybody else try to think for him, or are we none of us know at all?
I think, yeah, whoever would want to can also try to make the intelligence roll.
Flint doesn't care because he has his money. So it's not going to check.
It'll be with disadvantage, but I think it's possible.
Who is that? And I'll be like, who's with me? Who did negotiations with me?
I would make the roll, but it would be only to think back at the Smith's coaster, see if he ever dropped it or pulled out. Oh, I can't remember.
The last
shit.
Time I paid for one. Something. Hold okay, on. Well,
where's the real one? Where's the real one?
One of us.
Oh, they're both the same anyway, so it doesn't matter.
I'm completely out of funds.
Yeah, unfortunately.
So I rolled a nine on that. Good luck with that one.
Yeah, it is coming up blank. Dude, to all of you. You just
the come up, bro. The come up.
I don't remember you pulling out the pouch when we were at the blacksmith. Like you think you left it with the juggler at the casino?
No, he had. I think he still had it in the casino.
I remember. Okay, regardless.
Okay, so Erland's
we won't
broke.
Need money to survive. I'm dirt poor, so Erland's I will change broke. All my money to zero.
I look at Samuel. Samuel is broke because he revived himself, or we revived him and took his money.
I still got my incense, though, right? I didn't lose my incense. What did they take?
You still
exactly?
have your incense.
Okay, that's like 200 gold right there alone.
Mm-hmm. They only took your, you know. Cash, gold, coin pouch. Your coins.
Okay, well, someone else has to do
or dropped it, you know, wherever it happened.
Can I roll for it and use my inspiration on it and give myself guidance?
To remember?
Oh, guidance.
Yeah, you can definitely do that. It'll be normally with guidance. So it'll be intelligence with guidance. But... because it's normally with disadvantage because of the recanting.
So I'm going to roll it with guidance. Hold on.
That would be.
It didn't happen, bro. All of our minds were erased. It didn't happen.
No yeah, way. You never had money.
I never had any money.
Wait, roll intelligence? Wait, what happened?
We were all trying to see where my money went, but literally.
No, I know, but it's supposed to be what? Intelligence?
So it'd be what?
Yeah, this is just a flat intelligence to remember if you could have figured the time.
I guess this is a group effort. Everyone was like, damn, bro.
I'm 14, unfortunately, not enough. None of you can recant the time. I mean, you know of the times that you have been around, so you went to the juggler. You went, you know. To the rock rat, you walk to the boat. Unfortunately, Samuel draws a blank. You guys went to the priest to, you know, at the
we've been busy, bro.
The church, and basically, you used the money that you pulled. The last time was when you paid for Samuel's revival. Some point from there until now, all of your money has disappeared.
I look at everyone. Once we succeed this mission, we'll have endless wealth. It's fine.
That was their endless wealth, I reckon.
I reckon.
As I kind of shake it off at whatever, you see me start getting hairy and
hairy.
Kind of, yeah, hairy.
And you're already looking like morphing. A bum after losing your money. That's it.
Just money, early. Don't go crazy. It's just money.
God damn. his life's in the gutter already.
Yo, can I pinch a cig?
He's regretting.
This
man already has an only English and a Marlboro in his hand.
Are lycan wolves, like
werewolves?
Bad. Well, yeah, werewolves. Are they synonymous with like bad or in this astral plane, or they're just chilling? Have they seen a werewolf ever? Do they even know of one?
It depends. I think generally they are, you know, considered negative or bad. There's not like a lovely, welcoming lycanthrope society where everyone's, you know, cheery and happy. Most times they are, you know, small in groups or, you know, so little in number that they cause havoc in the societies that exist for them. So most places they are negatively viewed. Of course, if they're, you know, if a lycanthrope that had managed to hide itself and manage through its, you know, troubles through the group, like through their life, no one noticed, maybe it'd be fine, but they still exist.
So instead of seeing it, I kind of go hairy and then I go skinless for a second, and then you see my ears.
Oh my god, kinda, it's the wolf from Kim Possible.
My ears grow huge and I get big tusks, and I look like an elephant or a loxodon.
What?
I turn myself into
a. I like it.
A big loxodon animal. This is much better.
Oof. I like this one. That one's really cool. It's almost as cool as the hippos, but it's not as cool.
I'm grossed out.
This is
I just watched the transformation, so I'm a little grossed out.
He throws up.
Yeah.
This is when he went skinless, I imagine just like meat. It's just raw meat.
Straight flabs.
Yeah, I went from full hair to skinless, and then my ears grew bigger, and then tusks grew out. So now I look like this blue guy.
I'm going to loan you guys some money. So I'm going to just give him 250 gold so they could use it if they need to. All
right.
Six. Remember, when you sign up, we're sponsored by the Armory, and we have these shirts, and I show off one of the shirts, because I'm pretty sure I picked them up before.
Yes, you did go and grab them.
It's a yellow and black shirt, and it's like almost all yellow with like a black bullseye on the chest piece. And there you go.
Wait, but we're also sponsored by these people, and I pull out the Smith's Coaster shirts.
They have a shirt? I didn't think they had a shirt too.
Yeah, we got a box filled with them.
Shit. What if we cut the shirts in half and put them together and we sew them together?
And then I kind of how long will our name
my
be?
My sewing kit.
So that means our name has to be extremely long, huh? Because our criteria was to put in the name of the shop.
We gotta put in the whole name or just part of it?
Yeah,
we're not naming ourselves like our actual team name, right? Our group name. We're going to name it something
else. That'd be too suspicious. Yeah.
Okay, so let's come up with a fake name and then add these two names into it. What's your people's name? What's your sponsor's name?
The name is the Smith's Coaster.
Okay, so we have the Armory and the Smith's Coaster. So if we get those two...
The arm coaster.
The Smith's Coaster Armory. Yeah, there it is.
Armory. Yeah, there you go.
But wouldn't that just piss off the Armory? Because then it would imply that the Smith Coaster owns Armory.
Okay, so what else do we have? What's our other ideas?
The Smith's Coasters and the Armory.
Yeah.
Coaster.
Put in the and, separate both of them? Done deal.
While this discussion is happening, I tap Erlen on the shoulder and I give him a small sack.
What?
A what?
A small sack.
You just put a small sack in his hand? What is that?
Yeah.
What am I looking at?
It is 1,000 copper.
Oh, no.
Wow.
Here is 1,000 copper coins.
I'm glad he's to the start one. Of a small fortune.
It's 10 gold pocket pieces it. For those who are immathable.
Isn't it 100?
No, gonna put it's, himself it's 100 to silver, which is 10 accent. Gold.
Oh, I thought it'd be 1 platinum. I thought 1 platinum was 1,000.
So we're just copper. Skipping 2 currencies? Yeah, we just went straight is, from copper to...
And 1 platinum is 10 gold.
Okay.
So it is 1 platinum, but it's 10... It's, yeah, 1,000 copper. Right.
What if we name ourselves, like you said, the Armory and the Smith's Coaster of mm-hmm. the Rock of Brawl? All that.
Okay.
All together.
It's a pretty long name.
And? Is that a problem?
Not really, because it's just a fake name anyway.
Exactly.
I don't think the name really matters. As long as we just have their thing, our sponsor's blessing in our name.
Okay. So you guys are going to name us the Armory and the Smith's Coaster of the Rock of Brawl.
Go. Happy?
Oh.
Let's get moving.
2 thumbs up.
All right. Disperse.
Oh, back to thumbs up now. What is wrong with this guy? Can somebody figure it out?
I think if you destroy one of his hands, he changes.
Mm-hmm. So we've got Erland, the Loxodon, Shadow, Flintison, and Cruel, along with the group.
And Samael
are heading over to the sign-in booth. Are you going over, Yume? Are
you oh, you like remember to take your potion whenever you're ready to.
Yeah.
What are the other options? I don't think.
Yeah, what other options do we have?
I don't really have invisibility. I have invisibility for a minute. There's no way I'm gonna disguise myself. No, I'd try to stick around somewhere where I'm not noticeable. Try to blend in.
Seems like a low city there.
Act like a cleric forehead.
Okay, so as the rest of you are making your way through, then I guess that leaves Flint, Jadedon, the cloak, and Yume sticking back. You'll be in the low city, where you are kind of now. So, if you want to go out and do things or find your own way, you are fully welcome to.
Holding all the armory shirts, and I'm like, all right, I'm gonna start cutting up these shirts so Erlen can sew them together.
All right, I hope you all. I'll start cutting off the Smith's coaster shirts.
Let's do it back at the boat, I guess.
All right, as you guys make back, feel free to make a sleight of hand check, Flint, with advantage.
Oh my god, we're gonna drop the shirts.
That's pretty good.
With advantage,
Steven, of course he rolled well.
You do, you do a great job of, cutting it up perfectly aligned. Half of each end. It's gonna be a half and half, but it looks like it was purposely done. But as for the rest of you, Cruel, Invisible, Loxodon, Ireland, Shadow, and Samael, how would you all like to make your way to the arena?
Okay, so the arena is obviously less than an hour away. Right.
Yep. Probably like 15 minutes of travel.
Okay. I'm going to drink the potion. And so the potion says that anything that I change myself into, if it changes size, for example, if I get smaller,
mm-hmm.
I'll still get touched wherever like my real body exists.
Yes. Well, no. It's like you actually look or like you
yeah,
shrink.
But if someone tries to touch me.
Yeah, does this hitbox change?
Your hitbox changes. Yes.
But it says it doesn't.
No, it says it doesn't.
Oh, it does? What?
No.
Yeah, it says it there. If you use the spells, it appears in there. Yeah, in that
sense.
Gotcha.
Yeah, okay, I see. Yeah, so that in that case, it would be that way. So if you were to try and make yourself, a foot shorter or taller, then you would be noticeable that way, or fat or thinner.
Okay. So... I guess they know that we have how many tall people? There's like 3 of us. 3 large people.
I can make myself into a small elephant. I haven't said how big I am yet.
Okay. I will turn myself into a how tall am I? 6'4". I will turn to 5'6", and then I'll have a, you know, those kind of like opera masks that people have, or like the ones that they take to the carnival in Venice.
Masquerade mask.
Yeah, masquerade mask. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then I'll have a, and then I'll have a cloak, a purple cloak.
Gotcha. So you're Phantom of the Opera.
Yeah, he's literally the Phantom.
Phantom of the Opera.
Mm-hmm. All right. I like it.
Same.
Sounds good. And so.
Okay, so let's go. We have an hour, right? Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You guys head back the way you came, you know, straight to the intersection? Or are you guys trying to sneak your way through the back alleys? How would you like to approach that direction?
What not is your the travel way plan? We came. Mm-hmm. Right, team?
Yeah, maybe not the way we came.
Who else is going? It's me.
You,
Merlin, Samuel, and Cruel.
And Cruel.
Cruel is going to be, ah, oh, shit. Maybe they see invisibility. Oh, Cruel is going to shapeshift into a, he can turn into a spider. And he's going to be on Shadow's, like inside Shadow's cloak, I guess. Or something.
Yeah, you hear the voice of Cruel.
Hey, don't worry, I can hide inside here real good.
That must be feel terrible.
I look down, kind of like I jump at myself, like, oh my god, Cruel, what are you? A spider? Why not a gecko or a.
So many worry. Legs. Don't worry,
so many legs.
People don't want to look at spiders. It's all right. And I'm little.
But you're in my, is it, yeah, you're in my robe. Like, they're never going to see you anyways. You could have, I'll get used to the legs. It's okay.
All right.
Oh, Erlen?
On we go.
All right.
To where?
As you guys make your way to the arena. I'll say, please have everyone give me a perception check. As you guys head, not the way you came, through a different way, as you guys are now walking around, looking through, trying to see what you can find. Oh, shit, nice.
It's going to be one of those. Okay, I thought. Mm-hmm. My last three rolls.
Cruel can as
you rolled
well.
The 13, the last one, bro. That's above average.
Well, actually, no, Cruel's in the cloaks. So never mind. He's not perceiving anything. He's hiding.
Okay.
Yeah, so you know, with that. You all, you know, do a fairly good job. Definitely you, Shadow and Erlen, notice that it doesn't appear that, you know, the entire city streets are now lined with these guards that, you know, you all had found at the intersection. As you kind of are walking through and passing in one of the smaller, you know, alleyways or little intersections of the middle city and the low city, you do notice at the far end to the north, kind of up here in this direction, another intersection and, you know, kind of blockade or so, if it were a checkpoint where a different set of guards and individuals are kind of checking people. But taking the back streets, you all are able to avoid the kind of blockade or checkpoints that are kind of walking through the city, and you don't happen to stumble into anyone looking for your direction. So you all are able to make it safely over to the arena.
Nice.
Throw you over here out into the open. You all are still, is it 2 days out from the arena now? So you have the rest of today. It's about 2 p.m. or so at this point. And then tomorrow. To kind of prepare for yourself, but and then sign-in deadline is tomorrow, and then we'll find out about the rest. So as you guys approach, you see, you know, pretty open grounds. There are several, you know, vendors and carts outside. As you kind of approach the arena, it is definitely a more a buzz with activity. As you notice that the crowds and the individuals around here have grown. Protection doesn't seem as crazy or as, you know, open as before. not like anywhere near the rest of the city. And as you approach, you hear, you know, several cart and vendors and other people shouting around saying, get your tickets, right here next to the Prince Andrew himself, close enough to have blood splashed on you. Grape seeds, come on down. And other various people just, you know, shouting and selling things, tickets and seats and masks and eyeglasses and everything else to you know, help themselves as they kind of get ready for the day's events. What would you all like to do?
I'm trying to beeline it to the... I walk over to the first kind of flyer guy. See, we just sign in to fight. We got to go inside, right?
Oh, yeah. If you want to compete, you got to head indoors. They got the chief coordinator or something, I don't know. He's sitting over at the big booth. You can't miss it. There's several signs and flyers that'll lead you there.
Is it expensive?
Well, I mean, most people get sponsorships. I don't know. It probably, I think I've heard 100 gold. Is that right, Jimmy? Yeah, 100 gold. Yeah, 100 gold for a team.
Oh, not bad.
You know, unlimited, you know, a free wish of your choosing. If you win, it pays itself off tenfold. So, better be confident you win, though.
I walk past. Let's go, team.
Hey, those guys won't make it out. No chance. All right. You walk up to the Colosseum in all its glory. You notice it's fairly large, you know. Probably, you know, 70, 80 feet at least wide on the inside, as far as you can tell from walking through. Definitely the outside. There are many a grandstands around, as you can kind of tell from the height and the width and the size of it. Definitely could fit, you know, hundreds of people inside, thousands maybe, to view the spectacle. And as you approach the inside, you see that there are several, you know, large archways that open up around all corners of this building for people to enter and exit from. You notice there appears to at least be at this point your first view of some kind of protection or guards as they kind of sit out there, just kind of looking over you all with watchful eyes.
Is this where I sign up as I walk up to the counter?
And you see him look down at you. Well, I don't see many Loxodon around. If you're signing up, I want to be there for that fight. Yeah, right on through there. To the left, down the hall. You'll see that the big booth there, the sign. The Grand Logician is there. He'll take care of you.
Thank you.
You all walk over. You walk on through, and it doesn't appear to be a line or anything at this booth. It's fairly empty. As you approach it, you see it looks to be a large plasmoid sitting behind this booth. And as you kind of like look for his face in his direction, as it's kind of like circling around his head, you see his like multiple arms going out and kind of working on several different boxes and flyers and working on the booth with, you know, almost like seven different arms at a time or little plasmoid limbs doing all kinds of activities. You notice as you approach, he looks up to you and he says, "Ah, hello. I am the Grand Logician. What can I help you with?"
And I look back. My team would like to submit for the policy.
Oh, perfect. You all are aware of the challenge ahead that is involved, and of course the entrance fee of 100 gold.
Yes, I have been led aware. Your helpful manner.
Of course.
Quick question.
Mm-hmm.
Does the whole party need to be present?
Not for signing up, as long as you have the entrance fee. We can move things around if you not have full attendance, but Of course, we will have to have them there on the day of to sign the waivers and such.
Okay, so I look back. How many do we have again, friends? 7, 6?
No way, this is our captain.
Pull out my fingers.
Yo, make sure that Cruel is under that clause or not. If there has to be 8 people, because he's the 8th, technically, or if it's still 7.
So, what about an imp? What if one of us has an imp that follows him around? Does that count as a member? Do we have to put him down?
Is this imp entering of their own accord, or are they under the control or ownership of another one of your members? Would they be splitting the prize, I should ask?
It's more so ownership relationship kind of thing.
Oh, of course. If this prize is split, you know, on their share, then that is fair enough. They can enter as one if they like.
All right. You hear that? You hear that, Cruel? You're good to go.
Which one of you is this?
You're muffled, like, some shit like that.
Yes, any other questions about the competition of champions? It is a legendary event.
The brackets. Get the rules. Get the fucking rules.
How do you win exactly?
Well,
last one standing, kill them all. Outsmart them.
You all are getting ahead of yourself, but I like the enthusiasm. You must be very confident. Well, the competition of champions is a multi-tiered challenge. The obstacles are unknown to you at the time, but I will say they involve anything from facing, you know, dire beasts to, you know, intense challenges. Could be a many a thing, but there will be several rounds. The first day in 2 days, I said, oh, time is flying fast. You'll have 2 challenges to beat back to back with very little time in between. And then we will give you all a day to come back. And then the finale, the grand final ship, if you were to make it such far, would be on the second day.
Ah, so it's a multi-day.
Yes. Yeah, it's a wonderful accord. We like to give our citizens and those participating and watching in the arena a true spectacle. I mean, with the reward that is promised, we promise it'll be worth your efforts if you do succeed.
Understand. I look back. Do Shadow and Cloak look exactly the same as they... They don't have a disguise on, right?
No.
Nope.
Cloak's not there. It's Shadow and Samael.
It's just Shadow and Samael. Samael looks different, but Cloak or Shadow looks the exact same.
I just have my hood up. Robe closed.
Okay.
I can only see the blue in my eyes.
Do you guys mind... swap an appearance or, you know, makeup player?
I mean, we don't mind any...
Any rules against that?
No rules against such. As long as it's truly you that is competing, we are fine with any, you know, makeup or alterations. We had a team that all went in as Hadozi. They called themselves the Barrel of Monkeys or something. Yeah, it didn't affect their you know, their gameplay, but just something to think about if you were looking to, you know, give yourself a bit of a team theme. I don't know.
So it will be.
Wait, that's a good question. Is Dan going to be playing?
Is Copper with us on this one?
Is he going to do the Colosseum?
I was saying that mostly for Erlen, if he's going to include him into our group when he's signing us up.
Well, no, we need to know above the table if Dan even plans on playing. Mm-hmm. There's no point in...
Yeah, I was not planning on Copper.
Even if he doesn't, he would still be a part of our crew. That was the whole point of us rescuing him.
Yeah.
So story-wise, it would make sense that he would be with us in this.
He's not mentally recovered yet from the
He's
still broken.
He could join along. I mean, his character is there, and his choices are his own. Dan, I know at least, I don't think has plans to join us for further sessions, so it would probably be on the party or team, which I would probably rather avoid, you know, adding in, you know, more people and more, you know, rounds and turns just to not overcomplicate things. But
yeah, Copper is downgraded to filler character.
I mean, he's welcome to join, you know, in further things. We have Copper, you know, luckily still around if Dan were to be able to make it to another session or what have it. But
yeah, I heard that shit. He said if he's still around, he's planning.
But just having at least him, you know, adding in more fluff, I think it slows things down and it causes more problems. Yeah.
It sounds like DM's scared to lose. More teammates.
Dude, you remember those parking or those alerts we used to get from UCF when something happened?
Yeah.
I got an alert saying warning armed intruder in Garage A.
What the fuck?
That's crazy.
At least you're not on campus.
Yeah.
Okay, so I will sign up 7 of us. Me, you, May, Shadow, Flint.
You should buy
Cloak.
You should buy tickets for the king to be able to sit there for the finale at least.
Copper can watch him before he kills him.
So it will be 7 of us. Do you need names and anything, or just
the team name should help. And then if you have each of your individuals, it definitely could be helpful. We'll of course take this all in the day and have you all sign the paperwork required to compete. But all that's required now is your names, team name, and the entrance fee.
Perfect. So I look back at Shadow, the team name, and as I pull out 200 gold, well, it's 100 per person, right?
No,
100 gold per team.
Race for the team.
I don't remember the name we decided on. And I
stay silent.
It's look the... The armory of the coasters. What was that? Coasters.
I high key don't want to say it because I'm not there. I want to see what you guys come up with because I'm not there.
Can we give you the name at a later date?
No.
The Smith Armory.
The armory and the Smith's coaster.
Alliance.
It was the and.
There we go.
Alliance of Vengeance.
Warriors. The warriors of Smith.
No. Write this down. Write it as I look at him.
He's got it. The quill in the paper.
You got that? A R.
I can spell armory. No worries.
Armory. And.
And
the capital the Smith's posters Allegiance of Vengeance
of Doom. Doom's of on Twitter.
Doom. Of Doom.
Erase that. Of Doom.
It looks down the Smith's coaster. Vengeance of Doom.
No.
You, sir.
Most people are like the bad bandits. This is a little. I mean, I love the show. We're here for the spectacle, of course. But if you just one more time, please.
The armory. First, the is lowercase.
Oh, okay. See what scrolls out.
The armory and capital the Smith's Coast.
Ah, okay.
Allegiance of Doom.
And are those capitals you prefer?
Did I mention capital, sir?
Very well. He strikes the note. Of course.
Write that down. Write that down.
The announcer reading that name is going to be going crazy.
This should be quite a fun one. You'll definitely stir up the audience with this. I hope you all fare well in the betting circles. I mean, with a name like this, I could go either way. But I know, looking at you all, you should be a sturdy bunch of this. Just the three of you. The rest of you, I'm sure. But
that is a surprise.
We're all for surprises here. And the names of your party.
Our names?
Yes. The seven of you, you say, that will be participating.
Give me one.
Very well.
Thematics are important.
Of course.
Okay. I huddle. What the guy's name is King Kalar, right? How you spell Kalar?
I don't know if we want to announce his name with our names.
No. It's okay.
Why don't we just add blank doom to everything?
Yes. But we're going to start our names off with each of the letters. It's going to be a hidden message. Do you understand? I don't want to use your real names.
I see what you're going for.
So I'm going to be Sylvan, okay, but with a C. Write that down. I'm writing all this down, by the way. It's Sylvan. I pronounce it Sylvan, but it's actually Cillian. The name, exactly.
That's a first round draft pick name right there.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, all right. Okay, you get the A, Shadow. What do you want your name to be?
I don't know. Give me a letter. I don't have to.
I just A. You're the A of Kalar. Oh, hey?
I don't really know.
Help us out here, Sam.
The Assassin of Doom.
Oh, Assassin of Doom.
Wait, but yeah. Isn't he A?
Yes, Assassin. He's A.
But D?
No, everything is of Doom.
It's
he's got to be Sylvan of Doom.
Civilian.
Exactly.
And whatever.
Civilian of Doom.
Sylvan.
Wait, what's our name? Kalar? Is that what? Or civilian? Sorry.
No. Our name is. Have you not been here, Sam?
You just came back.
I'm so confused.
Okay. Our name is the Armory and the Smith.
Yeah. But as
an homage, we're going to. We have to give our name, but we can't give our real name. And I look around. Is anyone? Can I make a perception check? Anyone looking at us hurtling over here?
No, it is. I mean, no, pretty. It's a little bit chaotic around. People are kind of like, you see two guys like carrying like a giant like caber bar, like running around. People are putting up posters. Like people are setting up stands. It's a little bit chaotic. Yeah, they're definitely in the last stages of preparation.
As a tease, because we can't give our real name, and it's a multi-day thing, so we're gonna have to go disguise, okay? So we're gonna.
Hey, so you're saying Kalar
with
we show up as frogs for day one, and then show up as ourselves for day two.
Well, that might work if there's only 2 days.
Because we can't.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I was thinking of showing up as both days, and then we drop the disguise when we get the award.
But
we have to go in as fake.
Wait, but we want to win? I thought we were just starting the uprising during this.
No, we need to win. That was the whole point.
Oh.
Because when we get the award is when we display the king.
Listen, I'm not good at this kind of stuff.
It's okay. I just need names. So we have the Assassin of Allegiance of Doom. Was that what it is? Is that we're all of Allegiance of Doom?
No, Assassin. Blank of Doom. That's it.
Oh, so you're blank? No, it has A.
Yeah, Assassin of Doom, not Blade. Okay,
oh my god. Okay.
How have you survived this long, old man?
I look at Samuel, you're L.
I guess.
I'll name the rest of them.
Hold up. I didn't know if this word is not what I'm thinking.
Okay, I'll start brainstorming the others. We got set six others. Five. Okay. We're gonna make flip the other A.
Can he we'll be assassin also?
No, he's Asimar of Doom. He's Asimar of Doom.
Asimar of Doom? That's a very
That's a good one. That's a good one, actually. Yeah,
but he's not gonna be an Asimar. It's gonna we're gonna disguise him out. It's crazy, bro. Oh my god. You still thinking over there, Samwell?
Of course.
Okay, we have some more. And then we need a two. We need a two-letter word for the attic because it's Kalar. We have seven of us. Any two-letter words?
Two-letter word.
I'm opening up my pixel right now. Give me a second.
Wait. Two-letter words. Oof. Wait.
He cruel okay. Like looks up and says, oh, I'm
Kalarin.
Oh, I'm Kalar.
I'm a dude.
That's actually crazy. Okay, I'm Kalar. That's actually, oh my god, I give him a big hug.
You're gonna crush his fight.
You just killed the guy.
Okay. If you want, instead you can be I or N. Well.
No. I got the L. Don't worry. Wait, I or what?
Or M. It could start with you.
I'll take I, actually.
Okay, choose the I. You're starting us off.
Wait.
And as you're thinking, I go back to the guy. So when we give you the name, you have to introduce us in order that I tell you, okay? Do you call?
Telling this too?
The guy that we're writing the names to.
Okay,
and
yeah. He's like, oh, I'm...
Have you graduated school before? Do you need, like, the pronunciation sheet and everything?
I think I would do
you
just...
You know how to clap your hands?
I mean, I won't be doing the announcing, but... I'll make a note for them. Don't you worry.
I wouldn't
want you to mispronounce your
name. I'll be extra gay.
I look over at Samuel and I'm like, I don't think Erlen went to school.
Why did you just ask that guy that? You know, I'm kind of thinking that this turning into this elephant might have, you know, burned a little brain cells over there, but.
I gained.
Hold up. All right, let me write it in there.
Do we have?
All right.
Assassin.
This is what we're starting with.
Iridescence of Doom?
Of Doom.
Hey, let's do it, bro.
Okay, the M. Moron of Doom. That will be David.
Oh, moron. No way the smartest character got moron. There's no way.
I don't want to be assassin anymore. I want to be aberration.
It's fine. We can do that.
Yeah,
we'll just pronounce it Marid, bro. It's fine.
Bro, not martyr? Come on.
No, you moron. You should have came, bro. Okay. Oh, so we have the I, we have the M, we have the C.
Wait, is this working?
We have the A.
I want to be aberration of Doom, okay. Not assassin.
We need L, we need an...
We you guys are missing L and R.
Don't we need another A?
Does it sound better?
You had Asimar of Doom and
aberration. Oh, yeah, we have Asimar and assassin.
No, I'm not assassin. Okay. I want to be aberration.
Aberration. Nice. So you can fight for your name since you're here. So we need Eleanor, you said, right?
Yeah. New loser.
Who's left?
We have left. We have Yumei
and Cloak. And then Jadedon.
Definitely.
But I don't know what Jadedon
is. Jadedon is Marid or Moron of Doom. Moron.
Can I take L?
So you want to be loser?
No.
Okay, so you're not here. I'm making up the names.
Oh, we're not like telling you through Cruel through Steven?
No.
Unfortunately, okay. This is off their cuff.
Oh, yeah. Damn. Okay. Oh.
Loser of Doom. And the last one would be Yumei.
Wait, what was your idea, Nathan? I want to hear it.
Huh? I was going to say hit him with some false information. Call me Lancer of Doom. They're going to expect to, you know, me to lance around.
Nah.
Nah.
And that's why you're loser.
Jesus Christ. Our radiant virtue of doom.
Last season of League of Legends.
That's kind of hot.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Who's radiant virtue of doom?
You may.
Okay, because she's dark. That's good.
But we have radiant.
That's no good. That's way. Good.
Okay, so I turn around. Okay, mm-hmm. So.
Of course.
You ready?
Always.
So, as the name tells, we're the allegiance of doom.
Mm-hmm.
So he would have to say of doom after all these names. You understand? All
right, we're building suspense. You have seven people, but yes. I like it. All right, continue.
This is going to be a long seven intro for an important party.
I hope your battle is so, just as long.
You start with iridescent.
Okay.
So I'm going to repeat each one.
This guy thinks we're going to get first founded for sure.
We have iridescent. I-R-I-D-E-S-D.
I got that. Yes. All right. I like the theme you're going for here. Continue.
We have Morin of Doom.
Oh my God. He's going to spell all of it.
Not just Morin. Moron of Doom.
Yo, can we click fast forward?
Morin. Okay.
Skip the line. We have
skip dialogue.
Sylvan of Doom.
All right.
C I V I L I A N.
You sure that I you went to I
Sylvan?
Okay. Of yes. Doom. I have it written down here. Sylvan.
I have
like...
my degree right here, sir.
Okay. Yes.
It's like a washed-up map.
All right. Remember. The rest of your party.
We have aberration of doom.
Not abbreviation, aberration.
I'm going to misspell all of these. So it's aberration. Mm-hmm. A-B-B-E-R.
Mm-hmm.
N-A-T-I-O-N.
Abernation.
Haven't misspelled that one yet. All right. Okay.
Abernation. You ready for the next one?
Always.
Yeah, walk us through, sir.
Loser of Doom.
You really selling it here. Okay, yes.
S-E-R.
You just got that one right, at least.
Of Doom. Wait, it should be double O, double O.
You've heard this one many times.
L-O-O. I haven't talked to him in a while. L-O-O. Right, erase it. L-O-O.
I added it with the little thing there. It'll be okay.
Thank you. And put a little asterisk on the top, accent. It has
no way. No way. There's a footnote for this. No way.
It's got a tilde.
No.
Crazy.
Okay. We have Asimar.
I'm going to go walk my dog too at this point, bro.
Yo, just vibe, bro.
A-S. I M A R S of Doom.
Very.
That's how it's spelled, actually. I think. That's how it's spelled. No, it's not.
I think it's two A's.
It's two A's. Yeah, it's probably two A's.
Okay, and then lastly.
Mm-hmm. Let's end it on a bang.
Yep. We have radiant.
Mm-hmm.
R A D I. A N T
All right.
Z Virtue V R T U E of Doom.
Virtue.
Don't forget the Z.
Of course, we've got the Z here.
Radiant Virtue Doom.
It's a silent Z. Very nice.
Silent Z. Very popular in his culture.
All right. Well, I hope.
Does he need our pronouns
there's not
too?
Like a math challenge in this year's competition because I don't see you guys going very far, but
we're killing people.
I hope, we certainly hope so. Of Doom. Very well. You guys have sold it very well. Oh, yes. Very glad. Oh, well, I've got it all down here. Now, just for your entrance fee, 100 gold pieces, please. And you will be locked in, squared away, ready to go.
I start pulling it out. One, two. I flip it over. There you go.
Don't forget the 1,000 copper.
Oh, give me 1 second. I pull out another bag. One, two.
We'll just take this. We'll take this, yes, and it's when it comes time for the competition, extra. We'll have confirmed.
No, sir. I gave you 100 gold and 1,000 copper. The copper is for you to bet on us. Okay?
I think that would be a little bit of foul play, if you say. A little bit of inside betting. I don't think I could do such a thing, but feel free to bet on yourselves. That always goes well.
And what's your name, sir?
My name is the Grand Logician.
Of Doom?
Not yet, but if you win, sure thing. I'll change my name to that.
A pleasure.
I'll be back with a contract.
Yes.
We shall get to going.
You're welcome to sign it. Just be sure to be here at noon, exactly noon in 2 days. We'll have you sign your agreements, prepare yourselves. The competition will be in shortly thereafter.
No.
All right. Well, very well. Toodaloo. The armory in the Smith's Cluster of Legions of Doom.
Ask about the rules.
Are we missing anything, guys?
We already did.
The rules? Like items?
They said that, we wouldn't find out any more detail till the day of. He was like, you're getting ahead of yourself when we started asking questions about how the competition worked.
Okay.
So I'm assuming that they'll give us the rules.
Okay.
Oh, I kind of straighten up my back.
That was what's it called? The Ramus. Okay.
Okay. Of Doom.
I think they'll be real excited to hear our brand thing. And as we walk out, I change my voice. I'm like, man, that is. Oof. This is going to be hard.
You guys head back. I'll do the same. Feel free to give me another perception check as you all travel back to the group. I'm guessing the rest of you went back to the ship at this time.
Yeah, to tell them.
All right. I would say like a small thing I'd do. I like Xander's idea of paying the one dude that was the fake guy at the Rock Rat.
Mm-hmm.
Like giving him 10 gold and being like, hey, like we're gonna do this revolution. Are you in? Can you help us out? We're gonna win the tournament and you just come in and help us fight everybody. And I give him 10 gold.
Alright. You go in, he's still in the same room.
Yes, of course. I'll be glad to help. Sure, 5 more gold. I could get some real equipment, man.
Is it just going to be you, or do you have like an army backing you up?
Oh, if you want the army I have, that'll be an extra 15 gold.
Okay, so it's 30 gold total for you and your army.
Well, 35.
Okay, I give him 35 gold.
Oh, you know it. I'll be there. It'll be perfect. I'll gather me in my army, that I run in the city, and I'll be right over there.
You should put on some clothes, too. It's weird that you're just wearing underwear.
Part of this will be for improved armor. Yes. Oh, yes.
Okay. I'm excited to see what happens when we show up and win.
Oh, yeah. Don't wait. When my orbital laser cannon and army come in, it'll be something fierce.
Orbital laser cannon.
Oh my god.
Let's just pretend that the shadow mentioned it to you when we left that spot last night.
Okay.
So it makes sense.
Yeah, there you go. I gave him that money.
All right. You've given him 35 gold pieces, which he says, "Oh yes, I'll get right to work on that." Now, go and prepare. We'll need as much time as we have.
Okay, I'll be ready. Me and my team will be ready.
All right. And as you all go to get ready, Erlen, Shadow, and Samael's Cruel, making your way back in due time. As you're traveling through the streets, you're able to avoid any fair attention or any obvious checkpoints like there were before at the intersections. You're able to gracefully sneak on through without any troubles. You don't notice anything different, at least, apart from the general checklins.
Nice. We make it back to the ship.
And as you make Jadon,
you messed up one of the shirts. It looks like a crop top now.
Did you? I left my sewing kit there. Do you not know how to sew? That's like
I don't. It's my first time. Survival 101.
Well, we were just cutting them so you could sew them, but we did this one the wrong way.
Did you not realize? And I stand on the point that I'm butt naked from the waist down. I'm not wearing any armor.
As you all are going through your shirt challenge and having now signed up for the
competition. I look at Shadow. Mm-hmm. I look at Shadow. He has clothes. What?
It's because he's.
Why do your cats not like clothes?
Sheep to society. I never needed clothes. It wasn't really much of a problem.
I always thought he was wearing clothes.
I did too.
Yeah. I'm going to be honest. I thought he was wearing clothes too.
Wait, hold on. Where's the picture of your parents on this?
Yeah, as you all are finally noticing what has been here all along this entire campaign.
Jaden just had a 9-footer.
That's hanging
around. It's longer than his tail.
No wonder you killed so much of us when you were a barbarian or when you were mind control. We're scared to get hit by the sun.
Real weapon. All right, we'll take a break here.
The real battle axe.
Time to use the restroom, stand up, do whatever you need to. We'll try and shoot for like 8:45 to get back.
Okay. No way this man's on Genshin Impact.
I know. I saw him play. I was like, what?
Mm-hmm. Who's playing Genshin Impact?
Jaden.
I feel like that guy on curve.
I'm back now.
Take my glasses off.
It's fine. We can ask that the day of.
We're all here?
No.
Dio?
Nope. No one makes it on time. Come on.
Oh, Dio's not here.
Yeah, Dio was actually just here, and he said, oh, I'm switching over to my computer.
I got some food, I walked a dog, I got some water.
Very nice, very nice.
I got water, and I packed something else.
Wow.
Sir? That was a little awkward.
You ever think of your questions for the genie, Nathan?
Yeah, I already talked to Whitey about it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so we could do that now or flash back and say you did it before.
We could do it while we're making shirts.
Crafting time.
Real talk.
Yeah. Mid-shirt.
Fire stories while we level up.
Oh, I'll do this shit later. We all back,
girl. Totally. Are we all back? We showed up on time.
Always. My bad. I was here. I was feeding Cosmo. I just needed to pop back into the chat.
Yeah, no worries.
Dude, pedal.
Shadow's excited to go sit in the crow's nest for
this
a little while. You guys do our
attack. Really said, we're out here like always on time, and the motherfucker be falling asleep mid session.
I'm literally there though.
But at least he's on time. At least he's on there. Time.
You need your brain, not your body.
Alright, well, as we jump back in, it seems like a perfect time then to commit to what we were doing before with the questions that Flint and the cloak had for Ekbeer, and hoping to find further information. So having gathered your having some spare time in cutting these shirts and having figured out your questions, Cloak, this would be a perfect time if you wanted to either step away or do it in the room as you all are working together.
I'm like midway cutting through a shirt, like, hey, Cloak, were you ever going to ask Ekbeer any questions? Because we could do it maybe now. He'll pick up or something.
He'll pick up. No way, bro.
Now I reckon now is as good a time as ever. I tell you what.
Yeah, I mean you're like way more talkative now. So maybe it is the best time.
Damn, the worst part is these questions are like a little deep, and it's just like I have this dumbass voice now.
I'm gonna pull out the orb, and I'm like, hey, Ekbeer, are you there? Can you talk for a bit?
Yeah, not too busy right now. How's everything going?
Everything good with you? You sound like tired or something.
I haven't slept in a few days.
Why?
Lots going on. The whole simulacrum's dying off, and the campaign from Renegade.
I was gonna say, like, don't your simulacrums just do things for you? But I forgot that they're being destroyed. That's pretty bad.
Yeah. It's, I mean, they're not me. That's a good thing, right? But,
Beauty sleep.
They're still part of it. Hopefully sooner than later. But you wanted to ask some questions? Or what is it? You need some help?
I have one question, actually, but mostly my friend here wanted to talk to you. Just my question is really quick. Did you know that the spell magic doesn't work on Wall of Force?
Well, of course. It's one of the few things.
What do you mean, of course? It's like, that's news to me. I thought the spell magic was like a thing for anything magical.
you know, just like there is, you know, anything always, there's always one exception. You know, like you can't bring back someone that's been dead, that's been dead for 1,000 years, except for the Wish. Yeah, you know, there's always, you know, an out case, and Wall of Force and Dispel Magic, that's one of those. You learn these things.
How would I get through a Wall of Force?
Well,
I kind of embarrassed myself really bad earlier today.
Yeah,
I know that.
Yeah, Wall of Force is it's a unique problem to task, and of course, it is a wall. So like you would get around any wall, there are options there. It is not a perfect sphere.
I can just walk around it?
Am I in this conversation? It can be a dome as well.
I don't think so.
No, because you were with the rest of them, so this is like... you guys are walking back now, and they're having this conversation.
Okay.
And he kind of looks and he says, well, if it's a wall, then you could go around it if it's possible. It can also be a dome or a sphere. In those cases, nothing can physically pass through. But there is one way to destroy the wall. The wall goes through the ethereal plane, so you can't even like go to the ethereal plane, walk through, reappear.
Yes. So Shadow couldn't walk through a wall of force if he went ghost?
Nothing physical can pass through, even the ghost. It's a powerful spell. The one spell that does destroy Wall of Force, though, is Disintegrate. Powerful magic.
Oh, when are you going to teach me that one?
I don't think you're quite ready to wield such deadly spells, I hope. If you do, I mean, use it carefully. The name is not a metaphor. Yes.
Okay. I'll keep it in mind.
Yeah, of course. But yeah.
Oh, this is my friend, by the way, and I pull over the cloak.
Oh, hey! Yeah,
I wanted to talk to you.
Glad you made some friends, as scary as they look. What can I do for you, cloaked man? Woman? Child?
I can tell by a glance that you are a mighty powerful kind. You must have a great amount of knowledge.
I can.
This is I wanted this conversation to go, but I have to use the voice.
Slob.
No. I appreciate.
I got no clue where he's from. He's from some place way out there in the Wild West.
I mean, yeah. I'm glad I can, read what you're putting down.
Partner.
Yeah.
I had to be racist.
I have some grand questions for you, if you don't mind me asking.
The grander the better. Shoot away, gunslinger.
Has a deity ever interfered in the life of a summon?
A deity interfered in the life of a summon. Pretty frequently. The deities that exist, and I mean, many paladins and clerics, they receive this power from the deity. Well, the summons of those usually aren't, they're not quite known for summoning items, but they, kind of take on that relationship of, their source of power or font of magic. Warlocks definitely, with their gods and deities that they could draw power from. And their summons, they can, have some viewpoint and mess with them. Common, probably not, but ever, yes, I would say so.
Can a deity just create a summon in the wilderness for who knows how much time?
It may be how we all started at some point, so... I definitely think it has to. It's the only way, right? I mean, how did humans or you get on this place? I mean, we were all created by some god deity at some point.
Oh, God, the birds and the bees.
Wait, so you think a deity was what made you or something, Clue?
I'm not quite sure, but that does lead me to my next question. How do summons... who are summoned via spell or ability or whatnot, differ from things created by a deity?
Huh?
That was a misplayed angle where you could have said, what?
I'll tell you what.
I'll get there.
He looks, says, well, usually, you know, a summon made by a summoner, not directly from a deity, their magic is concentrated, channeled. These things exist as long as they can focus that energy, or as long as that magic can sustain that creature or summon. And when they have, you know, either, you know, cease channeling that energy as the summoner, or the energy on the creature has run awry. Oh, sorry, it's catching on. they just cease to end. But people, you know, like Flint over here, Asimar even.
That's me.
They have been created at some point. Their soul has been put inside them, and that is what keeps their flame burning. What it kind of creates their own magic, I guess you could say. It's what powers all life.
So Cloak has a soul.
Hmm.
Right?
That's right. Trying to find out myself.
How else would he make his own choices and fear the things he fears?
That's a bigger question about, you know, freedom of will and all that, but that's to be argued by philosophers.
We gotta find a philosopher.
One final question.
They're all the talk.
Mm-hmm.
What is the cycle of magic? What happens to it after it is used? Is it a great... How you... I'm not gonna throw in different languages. Because it works similar to the water cycle, where once used, it is returned.
That is a pretty fair explanation of it. For magic and, you know, summons, like I said, in those of the deity realm, warlocks, that they borrow power or gifts sometimes from that of their true source, the deity, some belief. You definitely can see that as such. Once that magic is used or channeled, it usually returns. It's a gift from its, you know, origin. Whenever that time does come. Now, people, it's a little more troubling with the cycle and, you know, souls and, you know, all life that's ever lived has been existed at some point and continues to exist in his, you know, an everlasting circle. You know, you are born, you're given a soul, you die, and your soul returns. This is much in the way that, you know, revivify another magic of that nature, bringing people back to life works. And of course, you can, you know, put the body back together, but what truly makes you is the soul.
Has the wrong soul ever been brought back by one of those spells?
Well, there's many times in how demons and other foul magic, you know, seeks to corrupt those. Many times, those looking to restore their loved dead ones, you know, pleading out will make a wrong deal with the devil or archdemon or who knows, and they can implant the soul of something very more foul, and you wouldn't know. It depends on who's providing you that power. Clerics are usually better at ensuring that the right soul is found and replaced, but other ways you can have very drastic and bad effects.
And lastly, does magic have a will of its own?
Well, it's a question you're asking a genie.
There was a time long ago where true magic was created and cast. This is a dangerous time. People have long forgotten it, and for the better. Back when magic was formless, it just existed through emotion and pure thought. The time of the pre-magic coordination days, even before my time. Yeah, that's. I'm not sure if there's a better word for it, but that's what we know it as. It's before even my time, when magic just existed and those that called upon it didn't really control it. They let that fill themselves and then they used it. Dangerous things were done. Entire realms, planes were destroyed. From the blinker, the whisper of a person. It's very powerful and very dangerous. We have since switched to using magical incantations, spells, even the deities themselves to channel this energy.
And one more last thing.
Please. Yes. I'll take a nap after this one. You're right.
I think he's getting tired. He's been working hard, man. I keep saying last question. It's the first time you said the same thing.
Can't get any grander than like you've been saying, I'm sure. So, shoot away.
As you are bound to your current living space, can something be bound? He doesn't live in the ball?
No, he doesn't. I know this about him, right? I know like where he actually is, right?
Yeah, you know that like he is a thing that exists, and like all of you.
He doesn't. This is kind of like a way we communicate, but he's like the whole ruler of a city somewhere out in our plane.
Now, tell me something. What type of genie doesn't come with some sort of container?
One that's been unleashed, and I have the willpower to do what I want.
Ooh.
But surely you must know what I am speaking of.
Oh, I understand there are a great many of genie who are still trapped to their devices. And
hello, sir.
Sometimes it's for the better. Not all genies seek to favor and benefit those. Me and Flint here, I hope I can bring him some good, and he can spread that good through the world. Other genies, they could be trapped underneath a rock for all I care, and I hope they stay that way.
Now, for my last question that I didn't actually get to ask.
Yes?
How genies are bound to their
receptacles. Just rubbing his eyes, like, embarrassed.
Just how genies are bound to their receptacles. Can something or someone be bound to nothing?
What are you saying?
Can something be bound to something that they don't know they are bound to?
Magic's like, a funny a thing. Can
be bound to a bottle, but they don't know what bottle it is?
Something of the sort. Something that would call the genie to find this bottle.
I guess. It would have to be very complex magic. You wouldn't know you were bound until you found the limits, I guess. I mean, I guess that there are some, you know, magic like when you summon a creature, it cannot traverse between planes. It does and it doesn't, you know, it ceases to exist or it gets returned back. I mean, this can happen and maybe you wouldn't know, but usually the summoner of that thing or the magic that created that would know that fact. I mean, someone made the limit, the bound. But the creation might not know it. It depends.
Can you teach it to me?
I think your friend has a similar contract about this. You can read his over and see if you agree with it. But
yeah, you have to beat him in a challenge if you want to do stuff with him.
Yes, when you make it back safely, we can talk about this training.
Yeah, Jadedon beat him in a arm wrestling competition. I've never seen something like that before. Mm-hmm.
And after that was mentioned, I get closer to the orb. You know, now that you mentioned that, Greybeard, you know, well, I've been wondering.
Well, I think I must be going. I'm very tired. It's been wonderful talking to you all. Bye-bye.
No, wait. I had about two or three more final questions.
I'm working hard, boss. I'm going to make it back. I promise.
And no response comes through as Neckbeard is sleeping.
So, maybe did that answer time. Anything for you, Cloak?
I'm afraid it has.
You're afraid it has?
You're afraid that you found answers?
Yes.
What's the answer that scared you?
I'd rather not say.
So are you a genie?
I would rather not say.
I doubt it. He's not nowhere near.
I doubt it.
And God, just man. As you all say that,
hey, bro, that was personal.
You hear a knock at the door as the rest of the party walks on in. You're on the boat, but like you're inside the boat. They knock on the door. So everyone else shows up at that point. You see Erlen, Samael, and Shadow all walk through the door.
How'd the signups go?
Doom! Well,
you might have to change your name for a while, but other than that, yeah, great.
Yeah.
I don't know who you are.
That's good.
What must we change our name to?
Oh, okay. Everyone, take a seat.
I just want to
really matter to us.
He's gonna spell it out again.
No way. I don't think our names really matter right now. As long as we're able to get in.
Just don't waste it. I just want to preface this with.
I'm done. Just continue.
Sam, your throat.
Yeah, I'm dying.
Oh.
I was going to say something and then choked on water.
Nice.
That's hot.
Mm-hmm. I would like to practice this with...
Well, would it be the first time you were dying?
Yes, doom. A lot of doom. Okay, so guys, there's a little bit of change of plans in the big scheme. So...
Now, pray tell, what must these changes be?
The competition is multiple days. So,
okay. Oh, good heavens.
Yeah.
How's that a problem?
The problem is, let's say theoretically we go there as ourselves. We make it there fine.
Okay.
We'll never know.
Okay.
Go on. That's the end of it. He left.
I still don't see the problem.
And your point is?
Yeah, your point is.
All right, guys. The problem is.
Okay. Erlen, you okay? Your tusk got in the way. I couldn't hear you.
Well, it's the extra plane. He's shifting out of existence.
You had like a little bit of a lift there, so I needed to.
No, the problem is if we win the first day.
Okay.
I don't know how we make it back the second day without dying. Because he would just kill us in between days.
I know it's crazy, but what if we just win the second day?
Are you stupid?
No.
We win the first day.
Uh-huh.
Then in between the first and the second day is a, I'm assuming, 12-hour period where they can try to kill us. Are you understanding it?
Yes.
The downtime.
Now I see the problem.
Yeah, so we most likely have to all go disguised, like completely different people. And then we have to win both days, and then we show our true self. Or we don't. That doesn't really matter.
Why don't we hide in that nifty little ore we found Flint in?
Hiding isn't...
I can't fit everyone in it.
Okay, never mind that. That would have been a good idea, though. Chat, close. So, yeah, we all have different names. We all have to work on either... If we can't change our identity, outfits, or just changing how we look. And then we're going to have to do that for 2 days. There wasn't much they could explain in the rules wise. We're going to learn the day of. And the fun part, I had to make up all the names since we had to register the name in. And we have a new team name thanks to, I look at Shadow and us. We kind of forgot the sponsor's name as we got there.
Oh, God.
So,
our loop.
We're the Armory, lowercase the. And the, capital the, Smith's Coaster Allegiance of Doom.
How did we end up on this name?
Except for the last part.
Yeah, how did we end up? Our thing was so short.
Yeah, ours was way shorter.
What happened to the Rock of Brawl, bro?
Oh, shit. I look at Shadow, bro. That was so much easier.
That's literally what we had.
Okay.
So we're going to Doom Angle.
Yes, I only pick.
Hey, listen, I'm only responsible for the of Doom. Don't look at me.
So we all have individual names.
Okay.
There's kind of an Easter egg in it. So We're gonna be introduced from top to bottom, and it spells out I'm Kalar.
Okay.
And I kind of point at my brain, like, that's pretty big brain.
So for all the people big brain, you were worried about us getting assassinated in between, and you thought it was a good idea to spell out the old king's name.
There's no way.
With our names.
There's no way they're gonna think of that.
What if we get like
no way you thought that was a great idea.
They're so into our team that they're trying to figure out stuff about us, so then they put the letters together and realize the message.
Yeah.
What if hypothetically the wrong people figure it out and the right people don't?
You don't know. Okay, back to the names.
Okay.
So I am Sylvan. Well, let's start from the top. So we have I'm Kalar. So the I.
Do you have a paper with this all written down?
Yes, I do. And I pull out my. I actually do. I pull out my book. Okay. And it goes from top to bottom and it like spells it out. So I forgot the name for that. So the I in I'm Kalar is iridescent. I point at Samuel. It's iridescent.
That's pretty fire.
If you were there, you got to choose your names. Yeah.
That's a pretty good name.
Yep. We got M next. We got Marin, which is you, Jaden on.
Okay, nice.
It's spelled out Moron of Doom. So
I can see that it's spelled differently, but we'll just say it's a pronunciation thing.
It's Marin, yes, it's a big pronunciation. We have C. I'm the C in Kalar. It's Sylvan. No, Sylvan.
With a C?
Is that how you say that word?
Yeah, I see civilian. Am I crazy? And I show Flint. Am I crazy?
It looks like civilian.
You just, they're silent.
Which one?
Isn't the point supposed to be that people are supposed to know what it is that the names are?
As long as the of Doom is known.
So Sylvan of Doom. We have Assassin. No, my bad. I got you. It's Aberration.
Yeah,
and then we have Animal. and it spells out
Aberration.
It spells out Aberration of Doom. It's some America thing. Just make America good. Make Aberration.
America? I never heard of that city.
We have, what's after that one? We have
what's this thing he called Easter earlier?
We have Lucer of Doom. There's a, what is it called? I forgot. Tilda, not Tilda. An accent. Who's Lucer again? Shadow or Samuel? I forgot.
The cloak.
Might I make an observation that you were the one that lost your platinum?
You know, I did lose.
Oh, that's right. You know, we couldn't find out what happened.
How?
We could?
No, I said we couldn't. I said we couldn't. Oh, yeah. We couldn't.
Yeah, who knows? Someone's living well, but whatever. It was only 100 gold, guys. Honestly, it wasn't even that expensive for the entry. Well, 100 gold is a lot, but not for us.
Oh, big money. Only 100 gold.
Ooh. Well, I had 40 platinum. Okay, last two names. We got we have A, second A for you, Flint. It's Asimar Doom. Very
head on the... You guys named me Asimar?
Mm-hmm.
That's the best thing I've ever heard. That's
we're
the
all
perfect name.
Gonna be in disguise. It. So you're not even gonna look like you. And we finish out with a bang. We got the R with Yume. Yours truly, Radiant Virtue of Doom.
Wow, Radiant Virtue of Doom.
I know that one. It just came to me, honestly.
That's a good one.
It was like this girl in a big shield and a sword, like was heavenly striking, and I made the connection.
Yeah, all these are pretty good names. Besides the fact that we literally snitching on ourselves.
Dated on.
But you know, it's fine. It's fine.
I'm Kalon. Okay, did you guys have time to speak to Mr. the man of the hour?
What man?
Oh, we were just making sure it's...
Okay. Well, we still got to bring up that we're giving away his nation pretty much to...
That wasn't the deal. It's just the lowest city.
Just the lowest city.
Immunity.
So, yeah.
I think he wanted immunity, didn't he? We ended up making him not be king. He just wanted immunity for his people, I guess.
So yeah, I'll work on these shirts. Let me know if you cannot or we cannot disguise you. I'll work on some disguises for ourselves, but if you don't have magic, let us know by the end of tonight. We're all gonna have to look different. I already have mine, obviously, you see, and I stroke my tusk.
Hey, you know
what? Well, I obviously don't have magic, so I might need help with that.
Yeah, I'm out of potions. Kind of tugging my pockets.
We have 2 days. We might.
Do you really need to be in disguise, Emma? I don't think they associate you with us.
I'm not sure about that, honestly.
Yeah,
I don't know how safe it is for you to walk around.
You weren't here with us on the initial arrival, so they don't even know your name.
Oh.
So I think you're in the clear. Safe. Yeah.
You might be safe. Who knows?
I'm gonna be honest. I don't think I'm going to be in disguise. I think I'm just going to hang out in my cloak.
There's no way.
Yeah.
You've been with us since day one. They know who you are.
I mean, but I could just be anybody in a cloak.
That definitely sounds like it's not going to backfire.
You know, this guy.
At least change the cloak out. At least do a different cloak.
He's pretty sneaky.
Sure. Why don't you just make me into a wolf then, huh?
We can make. As you can see by. I was going to turn into a wolf, but I wasn't. It was 50-50 on if I could walk the street as a wolf. Where's Kalar?
Let's go downstairs. Wait, quick question. Whitey, what? Mm-hmm. What does the Smith's Coaster shirt look like? What's the symbol?
The Smith's Coaster, the symbol was that of a sickle and hammer right in the very center.
Oh, yeah, the SSR. That's right. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I guess since we cut it in half, the shirt is now half of a bullseye. And the other half, what do you guys want it to be, the sickle or the hammer?
I think the sickle will. The sickle curve, pointing into the bowl. Yeah, the curve fits way better.
Okay, there you go. That's the shirt now.
Okay.
Let's go downstairs. Kalar. Oh, someone gets a crop top, by the way. I don't know who wants it.
Not it.
I'm gonna throw it to the ground. Not it.
I'm gonna be a wolf, so I'll take the crop top. It'll look edgy.
Okay. True. Kalar, where are you?
Go down to the rooms underneath, and he is kind of, you know, keeping to himself with his party, just kind of discussing himself, you know, things on the bottom of the ship. He sees you all coming and says, how's it been going?
Good for us. I think we don't need any more allies. We have recruited enough strength to make this successful.
Very nice. You must have gotten Azamala on your side then. How was that experience? I know you can be hard to deal with.
I think it really showed that we're a respectable group of people and nothing embarrassing happened. It was really good show.
Clint showed off his display of strength and mastery over the magic.
Prowess.
Give me a deception check.
Truly.
Who, me?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Good thing my deception is a +8.
He looks at you, stares into your eyes, and goes, well, that's great. I'm so glad everything went well.
I know. It was something special.
Oh, good. And he just signed on for the good of the rock, I'm sure.
Oh.
About that.
There's always a catch with him. You give him like a statue in his name or something.
A pretty big cat.
You must not talk to him too much.
You said it went well. Oh,
it did went well. He's on our team.
Oh, good.
It went well for us.
Such a big cat that I'm considering taking him out of the picture completely. But
so, how much do you rely on? Regardless, let's cut the chase. He has. Diplomatic immunity, kind of?
What?
He asked for immunity for all his crimes for him and his cohorts.
That's not crazy, right?
But...
It's just a lower city, though.
Like, murder? Like, you just go kill someone and I can't do anything?
Yeah, but...
We've talked to Ozamar.
But
if they die, like it was, it wouldn't have benefited your city.
I thought it was for the past crimes.
No, I thought it was all future crimes.
I don't
crimes.
Think we clarified.
Oh.
And I looked.
Oh.
Wait a minute.
That's,
loophole.
That's
loophole.
A tough one.
Mm-hmm. What if we do? What if we do immunity through exile, and we exile him after he helps us from the wrong?
That's a good one. Taking a page out of Eggbeard's book, huh?
Out of the contract, it was just immunity.
You know, we can find some wiggle room, hopefully. And I mean,
I am sure you have great lawyers.
If I'm king, I can do some things. Of course, you don't want a civil war on top of a revolution, but. I'm sure we can figure something out. He's on our side. That's the first step. We can settle out the waters after I'm back on the throne.
It's good to hear. So, yeah. We got 2 days. Choose those 2 days wisely. We're going to be doing our preparations.
Oh, good. Good. I've begun writing a speech. I think it'll be something to capture the hearts of the people.
Oh, let's hear the rough draft. I'm kind of a speech type of man myself.
I'm coming to work on it. It, you know, it's still a work, but listen to the starting line. All right.
Okay.
I'm here.
Okay.
Good.
Let's start with people of Iraq abroad.
I like that better.
Your old king has come to save you.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Why don't you go to you first?
I'm not gonna write your whole speech out for you, but if you need help, I'm gonna be in Captain's Quarter. I got you. You see this book? And I flipped through. These are all short novels. I've been working on some writing myself.
Okay.
Some help, just let me know.
Awesome. Well, yeah, I'll definitely come to you with some notes and you know, making a triumphant return.
I'm assuming you had someone write your speeches for you when you were in power.
You know, I would go off the cuff sometimes, but they were never as good. I mostly, you know, worked on the laws and things. Never much wanted to put my face out there.
Okay, so 2 days. We're gonna find a way to get you. And I look at the whole party. Actually, 3 days, and I look back at him. It's a 2-day tournament, which we found out, which is a little obnoxious.
Mm.
And then I look back at the party. How are we going to get him into the Colosseum? We just find him and put him in the crowd? We're going to do that all the day up. They were real stingy about it. Flint, big deal.
Mm.
So we'll most likely disguise him and then put him in the crowd, and then he jumps into the Colosseum when we win or when we make him invisible. You like that idea, Kalar? You jump into the Colosseum, take off your hoodie. Surprise.
If you can get me a good enough disguise, I'll be happy to take the reins at that point.
You're lagging real hard, Whitey.
You're lagging.
Kalar, we're losing him.
No.
CPR.
Yeah, I can see.
Copper got to him.
Oh, boy.
Hello.
Hello.
Rift to Whitey.
Kalar. I heard him say hello.
He died. He flatlined.
No. Copper shot him from above.
Someone take Samuel's life back. Give it back.
I stabbed Samuel.
Let me see. Is any better? I can still hear you all.
Yeah, better.
Yeah.
I heard you all like the whole time.
Yeah, you're better now.
You missed it. Samuel died again.
We killed him while you were missing.
I should have known. I heard you all the entire time. It was so weird. Like, perfectly.
I cast Spare the Dying on someone.
Well, if it's if it's a 2-day event, that also makes our situation even worse. Because if we leave him on the boat, there's a chance he's assassinated. And if we take him with us to the Colosseum, there's a chance that he's spotted and then assassinated.
There's no way people know he's alive. I don't think... Well, no, the king knows. Well, yeah, actually, if I was the king, why wouldn't I just go to the boat where I know these people are?
Yes.
Oh, my...
Well, he hasn't come... here yet.
Yeah,
but his guards are the ones that watch our boat.
We were literally chased out the city this morning.
Yeah.
Do I know
Do I know if the ship has hidden compartments or anything? I know this would not be.
This is your ship.
I mean, not necessarily hidden, like a false wall. I mean, like the cargo hold. Okay. You could like stack up some barrels and make a fake room or something like that. But
I got you. I got you. If we trust my magic enough, I have a arcane lock on my captain's quarter. He could stay there, and unless they really barge in and break the lock, he's safe.
Okay.
If not, I'd say the safest option for him. Actually, how much? The juggler didn't seem too bad. You think she would keep him safe?
I was thinking we could tell the juggler to keep him safe, too.
How do you like those two options so far, Kalar? Stay inside the ship behind the arcane lock. Hope that's good, or we sneak you with the juggler for a couple of days. She's a nice lady, somewhat.
I'm sure she's very nice. I think that the ship is probably our best bet. If you can have Ozamata do his job.
Oh yeah, he owns the docks. He owns the docks.
He could definitely secure this area.
Yes,
I'm on the farthest from Starhaven. I think that's probably your best bet.
Perfect.
Are you sure that's not going to take a little bit more convincing, in case Ozamata, you know, decides to take advantage?
No, he's already on our time.
I think I think you're putting too much faith in his word.
No, but his power is he is the most powerful. I know that for a fact.
So what's stopping him from just taking Kalar hostage and becoming new king?
Because he's not stronger than the king now. Us and him combined are strong. I look back at
the skinniest stick I've ever seen called the king.
No. That's not what I'm referencing. I'm referencing the king now.
Prince Andrew. The carrot cake. He couldn't take over Starhaven.
He couldn't take over. The exile, us and him combined, can rival the king. But him alone and us alone can't. So we both need each other. That's why he wouldn't just take him off. Just, we don't even need to mention the king needs savior. Just say we got attacked this morning and just to make our ship safe. During, we don't even need to mention the king.
Okay.
Do any of us even have message?
I have sending.
You may. We don't have message.
Oh, but you have sending. That still works, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, you should send a message. Just tell him to protect our ship, to make sure no one...
Lock down the docks.
Besides us, boards it.
We've been attacked. Okay, let's get to sewing. If you have disguise ideas and you don't have magic, let me know. Do some rough drafts tonight. Seems like we did all the negotiating. I look at everyone. How much gold do we have as a group? Gold is nothing to dead men, so.
I will look in the pouch and state I have 253 gold and 18 platinum.
I gave you my money. I have 71 right now. Gold.
That's a good one.
Huh? I gave you my money.
Everyone? I'm just saying, if we're going to buy potions, armor, anyone needs upgrades, now is the time.
Now, I know I gave you a generous loan of 1,000 copper coins. But just to let you know how much more I have available, I have approximately 700 more copper coins available to me.
Is that all?
I also happen to have 6,850 gold.
Ah.
I apologize. My handwriting, my previous handwriting wasn't the best. It's 685.
Oh, okay. 6,000 is quite the fortune. So, let's discuss that now. Anyone need severe upgrades on armor, weaponry? Anyone lacking anything severe in their utility? When it comes to me, the only thing I can think of is the scale mail. Not the best for sneaking, but we're in a coliseum. I don't think we're going to be sneaking at all.
Well, he did say that we're events that aren't necessarily just battles.
True.
But
we have good sneakers.
I think.
What do shoes have to do with this event?
We have no idea what the events are. Anyone can think of anything? Jaded on your weapons up to date, magical.
Wait, question above the table. Did I ever figure out what the dagger was?
Nope.
Or
the spear.
Or the spear. Yeah. I still have those, right?
Okay, yeah. Give me.
I figure out what those.
As we're mentioning that, you
back
should.
On the table. Hey, Erlen, you know, I never did anything with these. Can you figure out what they are for me?
Holy bro, didn't we get these like last week? Dude, it's busy.
Is it the graceful spear? No, mine is. I have a graceful spear and dagger. I don't think it's the same thing.
I kind of put my head down and shame.
Oh, you guys have cool weapons?
You need weapons?
Well, when you died, we kind of, back there, I acquired this dagger, I think.
Yeah, from the guy. Okay, so I put it in the cannon and I cast Identify.
All right, on the dagger?
On both.
All right. Yeah, you cast Identify. You know. Identifying the objects and figuring these things out, as you can, you know, now tell their magical properties. They are both magical items. The ooh. Dagger being a dagger of venom, you can see
animosity.
Here.
Ooh.
Yes. A +1 dagger, which will get to attack and damage rolls. It is a magical weapon. And then you can use the action to cause a thick black poison to coat it. It'll remain for 1 minute. Or until the attack is used to hit a creature.
Oh, isn't that what was killing Steven? That poison for like a gajillion?
It's a different poison. It's a poison that one shots you but doesn't kill you but paralyzes you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they used on me.
Yeah, similar, but this is a different one just for this dagger. So you are able to identify that dagger. And that one does not require attunement.
Oh shit, doesn't require.
So I look at the dagger, I say, we got a poison dagger, just free of charge, no attunement, no nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And then nice. I kind of mind transfer the damage profound shit.
Mm-hmm. And then you identify the spear to be magical, and it is called the Ruin's Wake.
Mm.
You kind of see there. It is a +1 spear, +1 bonus to attack damage and attack. It deals an extra 1d8 lightning damage, and it lets you make a reaction attack. Or you can use a reaction if you are hit by a melee attack to attack back.
Is this a two-hander?
It's a spear, so I think it can be either.
Oh.
Let me see what a spear is.
Interesting.
It's just a +1 spear.
Okay.
I think I think it's double. It's versatile. Yeah.
Yeah.
So you can use two-handed or one-handed.
Or thrown.
Yeah.
I mentioned that.
Those that's are the a cool spear.
Oh, that Sammo. Fuck. You got good armor, shield, sword. They're magical, all of them.
No.
No. Okay. Well, we could. We'll get you that sword and
spear.
Here's the spear. How's your armor? And I go Hey, him. What's your AC?
Well, I'm having trouble. My character sheet won't open, but
for some reason. Make sure I don't break anything.
Oh, that's because my character sheet is open. There's just a spear in front of it.
Cool. Yeah, that'll happen.
Not just any spear.
My AC is 16.
16.
And the spear does require attunement.
I kind of, if you want to tune this, you need an hour, Samuel. I kind of keep knocking on his armor. What is it, Whitey? It's just basic? Is it +1? Anything?
Samuel's armor?
I'm
pretty sure it's just what you had, which is...
Tell me, Samuel. What armor?
Chainmail?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that.
So it's not magical. 16. It's not +1 or anything, right?
Nope. I think it's nothing special. Gives you an AC.
Do
you
have
16.
Any leftover? You don't use a shield. You use a two-hander.
No. Yep.
Okay. So we should all have a potion. Let's get Samuel some actual gear. It doesn't fall over instantly. Anyone else? Let me know.
I would like to request a throwables or explosives, small things that I can deliver with without necessarily it being a weapon.
Okay.
Ooh.
Fair enough. That's all.
Wait, I think I might have something for him.
Perfect.
I have.
The less we have to spend, the better.
Well, all right, they're technically a weapon, but the throwing stars that apply poison as well, I think. I forget what they're called.
Then he wants a bomb.
The these.
Yeah.
Whitey, can you show me what a kachka is?
It's the bow that the...
Who are they, throwing stars?
They're throwing stars. I don't think they had poison attached to them, though. They were just stars.
I look at everyone. Half of the money. How much money we got, guys?
I'm flat broke.
I kindly refuse these throwing stars. 600. I cannot use these effectively.
We have 600 off of cloak, which is round. Shadow,
I have 71.
I'll tell you right now. I have 240 plus 130. 129.
You said 240 plus one? We got a little over 1,200.
Should we also include silver?
Yeah, silver is close to gold.
Well then.
10 silver is a gold, right?
Yeah.
You want to know my silver? Oh, okay.
Okay, wait. That might be wrong, but I don't think it is.
Where the fuck
it's been like that since the age of time.
Okay, we have like about...
My silver sounds really low for what it is. I don't know what I use silver for, but...
we have about 2,000 gold, so okay, so
hang on. 2,073 divided by 10, right?
Just take off.
Yep.
Back.
Yeah, you can just put like a decimal.
207.3 plus 71.
Yeah, we have over 2,000 gold, so let's make a shopping list real quick. We can send a couple people to do shopping.
Is there any armor that would give me bonuses to my AC without wrecking me? Movement and stuff? I don't really know enough to know what I'm looking for.
Yeah, so what armor do you have now?
I think I'm just wearing like light armor is what I have it under. Wait, what should
I be? Light armor?
It'll be a type of armor. So if you look at the middle of your character sheet, leather mail. Yeah, it'll say whether you have like studded leather padded. Or leather. If you have
This is regular leather.
Yeah, so if you have leather, you
studded could leather get... is just a one AC increase.
Yeah, you could get studded leather, which is still light armor. Do you have proficiency in medium armor?
No, just in light armor. Right. That's what I was looking at, my proficiencies.
Yeah, so you could get studded leather.
That's only like 20 gold for one extra AC.
Yeah, or you could look into the magical armor realm. To get even more than that.
Okay.
But said leather is
really
50 gold.
I relay the process to Erland.
Okay, well, I'm going to make a quick sheet. Anyone doesn't have magical armor? Let's get that out first.
I do not. I have basic leather armor.
Or a magical shield.
I don't have any kind of armor.
I have magical armor. I've got...
Just write it in the chat if you don't have magic. Well, no. Chainmail is a magic armor. Is your chainmail magic infused?
Is it like plus one chainmail?
I don't believe so. I'm checking now.
Yeah, it'll usually be, say, like chainmail plus one or something like that. I don't think
you guys you're specifically looking. Yeah, I don't think any of us have ever found a plus one armor.
No,
I have one.
Oh, we have a shield, and so yeah, you see
here. Oh, yeah, the plus one. The shield.
I have a shield.
What about the mariner's armor?
I don't have a... It's not plus one. Not plus one.
No, it's just armor with
swimming. Okay, well, let's go out, try to get as much plus one's armor as we can get these bad boys enchanted. We all should... How is our potions looking, our potion stock? We should all have a potion.
Regular healing
I still potion. Have a greater potion and a potion of healing. I have a regular healing potion. That could be right.
Let's all get...
I have one regular.
I have one regular and one greater.
How much were the graders again, Whitey?
It depends. Let me see.
We're gonna.
So, the graders, I believe, were 100 each.
100? What? Yeah. 500 gold just on potions, so we all have one on us. And then we have 1,500 gold. We can get like 3 armors. Samuel, you're going to use the spear if you're okay with that. That's magical already. Unless your character can't. Is it weaker than what you're using right now?
Where is the spear?
Go to the journal. Yeah.
The third tab.
Oh, I see.
Then you can like drag it into your sheet or something. I'm not sure if that's possible.
Not this one. This one's a little different. I can make, okay. if you want to use the spear, I can give it to you, like make a thing for you for it.
Where's the damage on it though?
A spear, if you want to use it one-handed, it's a D6. If you use it two-handed, it's a D8.
Okay.
I look at,
I think
it does less damage than mine.
But it also does 1d8 of lightning damage, so it
Might has an extra d8.
Oh, I see.
Just by its effect.
I have a 2d6 plus 4.
So you're going to get the plus 4 no matter what.
Oh, okay. The plus 4 goes on the sphere as well.
This is...
Yeah. So this is a 2d8, basically.
So this one's technically a 2d8, or 1d6 and 1d8.
Plus reaction. Use another hand.
Yeah, I've seen that.
Reaction attack.
He's just reading it. Oh. It also lets you make a reaction attack if you're hit by a man. Requires it.
Which is kind of lit. Yep.
And I twirl the dagger. I'm guessing you want it? Anyone else?
I will gladly take it.
Make good use of it?
I kind of take the spear, throw it around.
You need...
Have you attuned before?
Yeah, you gotta meditate.
No.
A little with it, an hour.
Okay. Process. So I just have to sit with it and basically become one with it, right?
Get to know it.
Just train with it for an hour.
Name it.
You feel the weight of it. You like. Okay. You feel your magical with it. Like you practice with it.
Taste it a little.
You already know I put my tongue on it, bro.
Whoa! All right.
I look at you and I say, "That's why the dagger of venom doesn't need attunement because you wouldn't want to taste venom. It's a complicated system."
I look at you. I'm like, "Is that what real warriors are supposed to do? Do you guys all taste your weapons?"
He's different. Remember, he's from this plane.
They do things differently.
Custom. Yeah.
I thought he was from our plane.
No, he's from Arp. What are you talking
about?
Different city.
I've never seen anybody in Arp playing through that. Different country, maybe.
It's a human thing. I'm not a human. Never mind.
How would you know?
Wait a minute. The plot thickens. We will go shopping.
All right. It's probably like 3 p.m. or so now, so you have a few hours left in the afternoon to
I'm gonna stay shopping
and do what you need to.
I'm assuming there's something to train on the ship, right?
Yeah, there's some. I did find the target floor.
Yeah, you can bring it up. I did find that target dummy.
You put it back, right?
Can you send a message to the person to Ozamata? Tell them to protect our ship. Damn it, she's gone.
Who's?
Jadedon's using the braces of defense, right?
Plus
two to AC if you're not wearing no armor or shield. You don't use armor or shield.
Literally wearing armor, but I'd never seen that item.
Oh, wait a minute.
When did we get this item? I've never seen it.
Please.
I bought it.
I know I bought it for myself, like for sure.
Yeah, I don't have it.
I'd like us to all be as well equipped. I don't know any barbarians that use armor. So I always assume you just don't have armor.
Oh, that'd be
Had this armor was because it was +1 AC. I didn't have anything else to give me a +1.
I can't use my glamour studded leather armor then, I think. I'm pretty sure I can't.
Oh.
It's armor, and I have to use the bracers when I don't have armor.
Yeah.
And my AC without armor
technically
is
studded leather.
I'm looking, guys. If we're not
Does anyone want this magic armor?
It's studded armor.
It's +1, and you can change how it looks whenever you want, pretty much.
I look at Shadow. Do you have an attunement? How do regular people work? They can only have one attunement?
It's light armor three. Too, so shadow.
I do not.
Oh, have three? Any
the limit for, I think everyone okay. is three.
It's three. Yeah.
Okay.
No matter what the level
yeah,
is.
Yeah, so this saves us some gold. This is literally free.
You can change how your cloak looks however you want with this. So I'm
perfect.
Gonna
this
glamour
knocks,
armor.
This knocks out everything. Oh, wait, so you're keeping the bracers, he's in the glamour?
I'm keeping
is
the
that
bracers.
What you're saying? Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Make sure you guys update your character
sheets. This is what I'm sending you, Xander. So that's if you want to wear that.
Well, no, it's a free plus one AC for him because he has. What did you have? You have
I just
regular.
Have regular leather armor.
It's actually okay. a plus two because it's a plus one armor.
Oh, beautiful.
So it's
wait, it's a plus two.
Yeah, because right now the one you have is like whatever it is.
Literally
so,
level one armor.
Yeah, right now the one you have is 11 plus your dex mod up to two, I think. Or no, it's 11 plus your dex mod flat. This one is a 13 plus your dex mod.
I wonder if I have that put on my character sheet currently.
What is your AC now?
15.
What's your dex mod?
Still, four. La, 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 4.
Yeah, so it's right now. So it's 11 plus 4. Okay. So this will be... I now have 17 AC.
Nice.
Jesus Christ, 17 AC?
Yeah, lit. And I got the dagger. Ooh, I'm in there.
I look at dude, the glow up.
Is my armor right?
Is
anyone using the shield?
No. I believe I am.
Okay.
Whitey, what is my armor supposed to be?
So you're a warlock. Right now you have armor.
If I put on those bracers on, so it's plus two, so I'm not wearing armor.
So you have light armor proficiency. So you're gonna be wearing no armor?
Yeah, because I'm wearing the bracers.
Yeah, so it's normally 10 plus your dex, which will be 11, which will add 2, so it'll be 13.
Why am I at 14 then?
With the studded leather armor would be 14.
I do not give a shadow the studded leather armor.
Yeah, so you with the bracers and no like studded leather armor, it'll be a 13.
What is shadow at if he uses the bracers, which is plus 2?
He'll be at 16.
Okay, yo, I can't give you this armor, Shadow.
That's okay, we're gonna buy one just like it.
Okay.
Wait, but the studded thing is a plus one or a plus two?
It would make
me be at 14.
You'll be at 15, actually.
Oh, I'm gonna be at 15, oh shit.
You'll be at 15, because it's 13 plus your dex mod plus... Oh, wait, no, 14. I'm going crazy? Yeah, I'm going crazy, sorry, it's 14.
Okay.
14 with the armor.
Okay. So yeah, I'll keep the armor then.
I look around. Potion check again. We have one
so
of the greater or 16.
Two. Yeah, I have one.
Assuming I take the bracers, right?
Assuming you take the bracers.
Because we're gonna go and shop.
I'm imagining we're throwing all our magical items out on the floor and we're like,
if you take off your leather armor, you'll be with the bracers. You'll be at 16.
Oh, no, we have two technically, because I look at Jadedon. You have the dragon vessel, which is always one.
Yeah, wait. One what?
Yeah. My point is more so... If I can all... If I know that there's a way to get... like, 17 plus two.
Armor
yeah, cards. 17. I'm gonna go for that.
So, with...
That makes sense.
If, yeah, so, like, other than the bracers...
would be the studded leather, right?
Well, you have
to. It'd be leather, like it'd be armor, like mine. Like
right. I have to go find that.
Yeah, so you can go buy the normal, like non-magical studded leather is easy to find. You just like say, "Oh, I go buy that." It's a common item, and that would get you to 16.
Oh,
can
wait,
he go to the? Can he go to the Mercane Agency and ask for the glamour studded leather armor there, since they can like find anything pretty much?
Part of the shopping is you could go there and have them either find it or see if they have other armor options.
Cool. Shit. So I'll just have Flint point me to that.
Mm-hmm.
Let's all just go there. It's right next to our boat. It's right here.
Cool.
I still, before we go shopping, I'd like to be disguised after earlier incidents.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it's light disguise.
So.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's fair. Just before we decide on who's going. So, yeah, before we, you know, do disguises. Who would like to go? Who would like to stay on the ship and train? What is the split here? Or other items?
I would like to go. I'm just broke.
I would also like to go.
I got my Excel sheet right now.
I would need to go with someone so I can purchase some items.
So I can procure some necessities. I say
on you.
I look around really quick. We got Samuel's weapon. No one needs firepower. I know you guys commissioned or got sponsors for weapons and shit. We're good, correct? We don't need to buy any.
Yeah,
should
be.
Okay, so just
unless
armor,
we find
potion.
Something really cool. But
I would like to make use of some daggers if we can find some
disintegration. Sure.
I wanna peruse the shop and see what's good there.
Yes, let's go to all the magical shops and shit.
You want a dagger?
I don't know why he wants a dagger.
I cannot defecate, as you say.
You can't. Shit, what? What did he say?
He said, go to this place and shit.
He can't defecate.
Okay, who doesn't want to participate? Like, who wants to join but doesn't really care if they don't talk or anything?
Me.
Okay, I walk over and cast invisibility. Once we walk out, I have like three more invisibilities to cast.
I'll use my glamour studded leather armor. Whitey, have you ever seen the anime Spy Family?
I don't think I have.
Do you know a little girl with the pink hair?
Anya.
You know Anya Forger?
I probably don't. I mean, if I saw a picture, I would like recognize her, but
basically. I can't really find a picture. She has these things on her head that are like these two horns. I just want to have these two black horns covering my wings, just like encapsulating that area. And then I don't know what else.
Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah. I know what you're talking about. Yeah. That makes sense. Okay. You get like.
I just put that.
Double yarmulke.
Yeah. Double yarmulke.
I gotcha. But yeah. Fair enough. You can make that this guy.
So who's going? You may stay behind. Samuel staying behind. Everyone else is going. Jadon.
Well, I can actually also stay behind if you guys are just going to look for stuff for everybody. But I will go.
Just come see what you want.
Yep. Everyone's coming besides those two.
I'm giving you my gold so that you can find me a upgrade armor, or upgrade shield. Either one.
Gotcha.
Well, I don't have a shield equipped currently, but yeah.
Do you use a shield?
I can.
The penalty? Got it. Free shield for you.
So I'm putting my gold to zero. Add 272 to yours.
You wrote it down here. 272, 2,000 silver. Got it. I will walk up to Cloak real quick and cast this. When I cast this, I will... Oh, my God.
Damn.
Beautiful in my head. Dude, I kind of tear out, like, gaps of your cloak. What color was your cloak, Cloak?
Black
cloak,
is my
cloak,
soul.
What cloak was your cloak?
So I kind of paint, like, astral rifts in your cloak so it seems like you're transparent and, like, you're blending in with the thing. And then I add, like, comets. It looks like it's going through you. Like, it looks as if your cloak is moving, like one of those... gifts.
Now before you finish
like
this spell, how do you
like flying?
How do you reckon I communicate?
What?
You just changed out your cloak look, I think.
Ripped out your cloak, not your hand.
I essentially painted on your cloak. That's all I did. I did some insane painting on your cloak.
Okay. And how would this help to disguise me?
Because you don't look like your previous look.
Okay.
That's it.
If you would see us.
I critical hit a disguise kit. You're not you anymore, bro. You're different. The shit. I think everyone who's coming, Cloak is coming. Cloak is sneaky enough, so I'll actually cast invisibility. Jadon, you're gonna talk a lot or no?
Yeah, I was planning on buying stuff.
Okay, fuck it.
What
so
the
I,
fuck?
I touch 10-4, Roger.
What?
We're not dropping
yet.
Hey, can't cut the copy. Over.
Oh, nah, your mic sounded fucking crazy. So yeah, I cast invisibility on Shadow and Isaiah. Onward shopping.
Samuel training.
I'm invisible now. Wait, how am I supposed to pick what I want?
What? You just tell
if
us.
If I'm invisible.
But just pick it up, bro. Or take my hand and move my hand to what you want. We're a full squad.
You guys are holding hands.
Aw.
Yeah, you just had to ask nicely. I'm more than willing to do it.
I look at you, May. Don't forget about the message, please.
Catch me back to speed.
Ozamada needs to secure the docks. And because we were attacked earlier. Yeah, protect our ship specifically. Right. You have the spell, don't you?
Yeah, I have some.
And you've seen them. Yeah. Viz exiled. We're attacked earlier. We kind of have a bounty on our head. Make sure our ship is safe in the dock. Good?
Roger, roger.
Samuel, after you're done, put it on the bottom floor where you found it.
What?
Of course. Talking about the training dummy.
Oh.
Time to get magic.
We're going to come back and train dummy. It's just a blue.
For real, bro. It's like all lightninged up.
Seeing out all the anger. Spirit is.
This is never happening again.
I actually really like that it has lightning. Whitey, when I'm using moves.
Yeah.
Can I like make the move as long as it's in the like what the spirit does, like for example the lightning, could I make it like look how I want it as long as it's within range and stuff?
100%.
Okay, cool.
That's my
When you are That's attacking with this, you get to describe what it looks like. You get to put some spin on it, you know. It just know that the other damage is damage, but like you flavor your attacks and your movements and however you want to. So yeah.
Okay, cool.
Please definitely love to have you, you know, describe the animations you do or your attack style. All right.
Just don't make it gay.
Yeah. And what's wrong with that?
Mm-hmm.
You just saying don't do it.
Oh shit. Wait, right before we go, Yume, how many messages do you have? Remember, you can use higher level.
Yeah, but I haven't used a single spell slot today, so I have a lot.
Okay.
I love the image in my head of hearing you may say, homie.
Yo, bro.
I got 5 summons.
Ask Ozamada and both the juggler if they know any good magic shops, any good vendors that we can get. Maybe if they're underground, shady, the best. Armor smiths and shit. Before we go, I'll save us some time wandering.
You can. All right, fucking 25 words. all right, so I cast sending to Ozamada.
All right.
This doesn't count. Give me a second.
1, 2, 3, 4.
We're calling to check on your
extended warranty.
mm-hmm. This is the wave of exile. We have made purchase on our ship and need protection from the law. Been made
from the law
and are not sure.
You're done. That's it.
That's 25. Yeah. I recast sending.
When you got to end our
recast sending. No, but I'm gonna chain sending.
Okay.
And all are right. Sure. So I got another 25.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
If we have been tailed, we are located at the docks on our ship. That should be 8.
That was like 14.
You don't know how to count.
Really?
God is that.
Pretty sure I'm going with 14.
So 14 is ship. Do you have any vendors or shops where we may find?
That's it.
And I'll chain one more.
All right.
Oh my god.
So this is the third spell slot.
All those mana. Gotcha.
As you're doing all this, Erlen is writing like a short and concise, like,
we're just like an actual letter.
Valuable gear and information for our venture forth. And then the rest of it is just like silence. It's radio silence for like 17 words.
You see, that's pretty funny. You hear several paces past, and then a similar voice. Ah, well, I'll be sure to send extra protection to the docks. Yeah, I wouldn't want our prized possession to go squandered now, would we? And as for vendors, the American agency, renowned across
write that down.
The astral plane.
Space we're going to.
I'm repeating all this as he's saying it.
Mage's Guild Hall may have scrolls, potions, elements you may want. Armor of the like, generic items, the armory, the smith's cluster, a few other smiths around may be able to help you.
I got the...
Library of Spheres, both some knowledge, information if you need to do a reading or two. Gaspar's Reclamations. You know, old kook, but he's got some interesting finds.
Bro, he has special magic. He used like 40 words to reply.
He's just chain CCing it.
Nobody
he's
did.
Got
the chain CC.
Oh, yeah, reply,
yeah. You know, you get 75 words to respond back. And he kind of... That should
guys,
be
we're
all.
So good at science.
I look at you, mate. Here, for the juggler. Real simple. Do you know any good vendors for magic, armor, or spells? And then, shopping before battle, period. Erlin, the Wave of the Exile.
All right, so I burnt that. I burnt the last... well, I burnt one more, and I only have one sending left on that note.
So that's what we sent to the jungler.
The jungler. Mm-hmm. He sent that shit to fucking Karthus, bro.
Dear Karthus, I hope you good health. Have you seen that meme?
Oh, Karthus, yeah.
Just message press R. Dear Karthus, I wish you good health and prosperity. I would love it if you could assist. So yeah, we asked if she knows any good vendor for magic weapons or spells. We're shopping before battle. Dear Erlin, the weather. So. Does she know any different places, or she says about the same thing?
She responds.
Any shady places?
Pretty much the same. She one thing she adds. I'm not sure it'd be much help, but Elmanda's star charts can be of some use if you need to plan any greater wraparound of town or of the areas around the rock.
Oh, that could be useful.
Star charts. We do need to get there. Yeah, we need to get there safely. We can get the king there safer. That's important. Okay. Thank you, man.
Right, let me see that. That's
onward. Let's go to familiar territory first. You want to go to the coast and the armory?
The Mercade Agency?
I said the Mercade Agency is like right outside of the docks. So okay. In terms of
that's for like spells and stuff, right?
Magical items mostly.
Okay, perfect. Let's go to the hell.
All right. You all make your way there. Other than Yume, I believe, and Samael, is that right?
Yep.
Alright. I'll just throw you guys back just to make sure. Alright. The rest of you moving on to the Mercane Agency.
Doodum.
You.
Well, Ripper left.
Ha
ha ha.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, making your way through. Say, go ahead.
No, I was just going to look at the party. Who's our good negotiators again?
Me.
None of us.
I have, what's it called? What's the spell called, Whitey? You know, right?
What's the, why do you know what I'm talking about, Whitey? What's
come
the
on,
thing?
Dog.
Hey.
Come on, Whitey.
Do you mean like that rustic hospitality thing?
No, it's an actual spell.
Oh, is it your divine
artist
spell? Yeah, it's your channel divinity, right? It's like the persuasion.
Yeah.
It's part of your channel divinity. It's one of those things. I can't remember what the name is. I can look and see.
I'm trying to see.
Rip, we're gonna bring him. You train him, big dog.
Hey, you ain't come.
Yeah, okay. Play you when we're talking about prices and sell. Yeah, the man. I'm persuasion, nice. And I say, I kind of do like a mock persuasion. I'm like, so you see this pencil right here, this canvas right here can feed a family.
Sell me this pen.
Okay.
And I give him the pen.
Oh shit, my bad.
And I look at it, and I stab my leg, and it starts bleeding. I do 1 point.
No way.
This pen right here can save your life.
What was the point of that?
If you ever need to defend your. What? That's not how you sell. And I kind of look at the blood and stuff. And then I pull out a book. I pull out the book and push out the pen. Even after you defend yourself and I scribble on my notebook, you can still write notes and it's like blood smearing down my pain.
What? They come with their own ink.
Take that as you will.
Yeah, I'll leave the negotiating to you.
Yeah, that thing, that channel divinity thing's pretty good.
The next 10 minutes, hold on.
Yeah, so for reference, with your channel divinity, your persuasion will be +9. Or no, it's a +6.
Tim, you want to get +1?
I'm actually a better liar than I am a persuasion person, but my persuasion has a good bonus too.
My persuasion actually has a +5.
Oh, you're the same as me then. For persuasion.
You're invisible. Okay, what do we see inside this market? We looking.
Yeah, so you walk into the Mercane Agency, a place you've not been before, but have walked many times and have noticed its unique purple and pink in alternating stripes colored like tent almost that stands about amongst the low, you know, the low cities kind of hovels and shacks. Something definitely is stuck in your mind, but not having decided to walk in, you see now the top of the front of like the flap of the tent, a kind of written in Comic Sans, the Mercane Agency.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm. As you open the flap of the tent, you are immediately greeted by a giant room, you know, similarly matching, you know, wacky pink and purple alternating stripes coating the walls. You see kind of a you know, maybe like 10 feet in front of you, a wooden, you know, counter with various kind of ornamental items sitting atop a vase, a pair of gloves, a bow of some kind. And then you see standing behind the counter a Mercane.
This is groovy.
Which
lights are crazy.
For those who don't you know exactly what that is, they are an interesting interesting, you know, set of creatures.
Is there music like playing here? Like club music?
It's like a, it's not quite a club music. It's like a carnival, like. Like the Benny Hill theme, with like trumpets and like interesting horns. Yeah, exactly. But behind it, you see a 20-foot tall blue giant. 20-foot tall.
What the fuck?
Jesus Christ.
Just a symbol of what it looks like behind the counter.
Holy moly.
Standing there, a massive Mercane looking at you with his monocle and eye. You have various rings and gems and his illustrious robe and collar. And he looks down at you and says, "Why, hello."
Hey, man, I dig the vibes in here. It's pretty fun.
A trait of us Mercane.
You guys seem so joyful and happy.
We
very kinda, lively people.
Shadow kind of like scoffs and laughs under his breath. Joyful, yeah, for sure.
So, you like magic and...
We are the Mercane. We control magic items and the flow of them. You need it, we find it.
Like anything?
Anything. Our agents are interdimensional, traveling through planes, finding these things. It is the job of the Mercane.
It's absolutely insane. Did you used to be one of those agents and then you got your own shop or?
I am part of the guild.
Okay. Retirement coming soon?
We
maybe if we make a big sale, you retire soon, huh?
We live for several hundred thousand years. Retirement is not quite planned.
100,000?
But I bet in all those 100,000 years, you've never seen a group quite as good looking as this one right here. I look back at everybody.
Kind of flare my ears out.
Interesting to say the least. But it definitely looks like you would be interested in magical items.
We would. What do you have in store for us here at present?
We are the Mercane Agency. What do you want from us?
I haven't really thought about that. So, will anyone have requests?
Magic light armor.
Very well.
Or just magic armor, and we can like look at between the light and the heavies.
Am I invisible? Including shield.
Invisible armor.
Very well. Are you interested in plain armor or unique armor?
Ooh, I want to hear the unique stuff. I want to see what the special stuff is. But we could probably take a look at plain armor too. Is there like a big... Like I look around...
Bro,
is it
all who just stole my gold, bro? Who the hell did that?
Our gold.
Literally. Who stole our gold?
Yeah, think about it. He says, well, we have everything available to us. Maybe not right now, but most now.
Just show me your catalog.
We're actually going to be in the Coliseum in like tomorrow, so.
Two days.
If you're looking for a sponsor.
Oh, no.
No sponsor.
We're adding more to the list.
We are the Mercane. Our name carries its own.
Fair enough. Should.
And he looks at you and says, we have all of these magical armors, studded leather, padded. If you need medium armor, we have that as well. As for...
Do you have adamantine armor?
Adamantine, yes.
No way you're about to spend our money for your selfish armor.
No, I'm not.
What was the unique armors?
for unique armors, we've got some pretty cool things. This here armor is the armor of resistance.
Just a little tip. The younger people don't use the word cool anymore. We say groovy. So if you, instead of saying cool things, just say there's like groovy things.
Let's groove tonight.
This is pretty groovy. This is
incredible.
Plus one studded leather armor that also gives you resistance to radiant damage. Very thrilling.
Yeah, I'm already radiant, so I guess it wouldn't really help me much, but maybe it could help you guys.
Very well. Here is the armor of safeguarding. You see this rune here?
Yes.
If you wear it, it gives you an extra 20 health. Makes you very hard to kill. And it gives you a beacon of hope.
That's pretty crazy.
This guy sounds like a joy.
Yeah.
Welcome to the
he really fits groovy. He really fits the setting.
Yeah, he sounds really groovy.
This is the 20 health thing. This is pretty cool. What is it? Like a rune you put on, or it's armor with a rune on it?
It has a rune on the inside.
Okay.
You activate it as part of your time, and it gives you a beacon of hope.
I look at him. You say any magic
that we can find.
Any. Do you have an amulet of plane shifting?
Amulet of plane shifting.
Uh-huh.
He sits there. He thinks about it.
There's no way he has.
We're about to just take off. Not even.
This would have circumvented literally the whole plot.
He goes.
It exists. Amulet
of the planes. Yes. Uh-huh. This exists. We do not have it right now.
You.
I can have it to you in 7 days.
How convenient.
Quite nice. Lets you make the plane shift spell with the right check. Great for leaving on a quick getaway.
This motherfucker doubled down. He said quite nice.
He's like, yeah, that would be good. I hate this.
Is there any other unique armor?
We have a tunic for two.
Maybe a shield? Because I use this bat a lot, but I don't use it much anymore, so maybe I could have a shield in one hand and then shoot out these Eldritch Blasts in the other for more usefulness. If there's a cool one.
Tell us about your shield. I think we're above the table. I think we're looking for three shields. Or two shields, two armors. You may want a shield. You want a shield. And then me and Xander can both use armor upgrades, ideally.
Okay. Yeah. I only really want a shield, like, based on if it does some crazy unique thing, but I don't really care about the other bonus the shield gives.
Yeah, he looks at you and says, we have many a magic shield. Normal, if you're interested in special, we have the shield of missile attraction, giving you resistance to attacks from ranged weapons.
And we have that already.
An arrow catching shield.
Those are two different shields?
Yes. This one lets you catch an arrow.
Well, that doesn't sound as cool in your voice, you know. I thought it was cool at first, and then you said it so dryly that I was like, huh.
Less catching an arrow, and more if an arrow is shot near you, it goes to you. Quite nice.
Shot near me, it goes to
you. You all seem interested in some of the more fine items, I will offer you our best Archman. This is the animated shield. Activating the shield, it'll float around you and protect you, leaving your hands free for the better of working on items, using your hands to attack, whatever the need.
That sounds pretty cool, actually.
That would kind of go crazy with my fighting style, just saying.
I don't think I would need it, but someone else, yeah, like Shadow could use it. How much is the animated one?
The animated shield, 1,500 gold pieces.
What?
Yeah, we have about like 2 points.
Well, okay, so if we were just looking for like a plus one, if you know what that means, plus one shield and 3 plus 1 armors, how much would that come out to?
3 plus 1 shields, 3 plus 1 armors. That would be 1,500 gold pieces.
Really?
We got extra. We got extra money.
We have extra what?
We have extra funds that we can spend. Let's save about like 400 for potions ish.
Wait, you ask have, about something like your armor.
Do you have anything like the armor I'm wearing right now, this glamour studded leather armor?
Glamorous studded leather armor. We have similar. If you're interested in the same power, we have such things as the armor of vulnerability.
Armor of vulnerability?
Yes.
Quite what does nice. It do? It's different from mine?
It gives you resistance to damage types. If anyone were to slash at you, it would be better for that. Very nice for fighting swords.
Okay. Are you interested in that, Shadow, or no? Okay.
I don't think he wants to talk.
Oh, wait, am I muted?
Yeah, you were.
Was I?
Yeah. Well, I didn't hear what you said when I asked you that.
I said, I don't know. Just kind of let Erlen pick. He knows more about what's going to work for me, I guess.
Okay. Erlen, what are you thinking?
Plus 2 sounds crazy, though. That's 17. Just saying.
I think that's what the armor of vulnerability would give you, I think. I don't know.
If you're looking for greater protection, may I offer Elven Chain? Wears like chain, feels like light armor.
It's a good slogan.
Yes. Even without practice in medium armor, it'll give you +1 bonus AC to chain mail armor.
So it's technically a +2?
Does it give you the -1 on stealth?
No, I don't think the Elven one gives you minuses. Well, I don't know. I have no idea.
It does not. So it does not have the whatever it is, the disadvantage, the stealth.
Disadvantage? Yeah. Mm. So what are you thinking, guys?
Chain shirt doesn't anyway, so it does. It wouldn't. Or is it chain mail? What is it?
But is that Elven chain mail? Is that like a +2 to AC? Because that's what Xander's looking for, I'm pretty sure.
Well, I don't know exactly what I'm looking for, because I don't
it's
know
a chain enough about shirt. Armors. It's not a heavy armor. So it would be, it's a 13 +2 with your dex plus another 1, so it'd be 16.
Okay. I'm just not well versed enough in items to really know what I'm looking for. That's why I'm kind of just like,
Sure that none of us really care besides Steven, like special effects on our items, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we're just looking for that. So,
well, if I find a special effects on mine, I'll take it.
I am not gonna buy anything from here. I can tell right now. I don't think I'm gonna get anything.
I'm most likely just looking for.
I mean, if it's like a really broke like effect that's really gonna help me out with like. Kind of fighting mid to close range.
We're gonna be here all day. I look at him. How much would it be for a +2 heavy armor?
+2 heavy armor. Now that is a defensive piece. For which armor in particular?
Heavy.
Ring mail, chain mail, splint mail. Plate mail.
I'll be
Let's do scale mail. So, give me 1 second. Look at your scale mail for now.
Scale mail is a medium armor, but.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, do I use medium armor? Hold up. I'm about to blow my own mind. Oh, I am a meat. I forgot I'm a caster. My bad. I'm so used to it. Scale mail is 14. Half plate is expensive. What about your half plate?
In +2.
Hmm.
Half plate +2, 5,000 gold pieces.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Shit. Do you have any bulk deals? How about we do like a bulk order of a shield and then three plus one armors, or maybe something different than somebody else wants. And we do a bulk order on a discount, and I'll give you a book that teaches you some other cool lingo so that you could use it on the younger generation so that you make more sales.
Yeah. Well, we pretty much
give me
I want an armor. Yeah. Let me actually think the actual details though.
Can anyone give me the help action so I can get an edge on this persuasion?
We don't got guidance here, bro, but I will help. And I will help by kind of specifying. So we want 2 shields and 2 armors. And if you can fit a +2 into our budget, we'll take it on the spot. Medium and light. We don't have any heavies.
Or any bracers.
Does that give me advantage?
I don't know about advantage. That was my assist.
Sure. We'll take it with advantage.
What an assist.
I'm different, bro.
What an assist.
Mm-hmm. I just gave him my notepad, like in the checklist.
All right. I'm 22.
In the background, I have Cruel writing down on a piece of paper words like groovy, riz, woke, like all these words. That
no cap, bless up.
Opium.
On my mama. Mm-hmm. On my mama.
He goes, well, for my homies, I guess. 10%.
Big dog.
You're a real one, big dog.
10%.
That was an amazing conversation.
Wait, what was it? What was the discount? I didn't hear it.
10%. If okay, you so, come back from the arena, you'll have lots to spend.
So 10% off of what we want to get, which is 2 shields and 2 armors. I'm not sure the specifics of the armors that you guys want. Actually, it's only 1 shield, isn't it? I don't want the shield. I don't care about the shield.
You may want the shield. So just one. And I'll take a scale mail. And really quick, do you have a spare ring of spell storing? And I kind of take mine off. Another one like this.
Mm-hmm.
I did.
Ring of spell storing. They're not too rare. Let me look at that real fast.
What just happened?
Where do I have this hiding? Ring of spell storing. Aha.
For you,
400 gold.
Oh, that's not the best.
Oh, you fuck off.
And then, this right quick, Whitey, does he have this?
Let me...
It's see. A specific item in the journal, or compodium.
Yeah, let me look it up real fast.
Oh god, let me look it up means this is about to be expensive.
This is bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're gonna need to have a cutoff on We're gonna need a cutoff on Erlen's budget, bro, because he's kind of using our money.
Well, no, that's Yume.
Yume gave him
A lot of this is Yume.
Mm-hmm. He sees it and says,
bro, I am on the front line with you, so if he has a plus two jaded on, I'm standing right next to you, bro. I'm getting hit.
That's true.
Flynn does not get priority on armor.
I found what I'm going to ask for.
He looks at it and says, I could have this by tomorrow morning.
How much?
For this.
He has a French accent now.
400 gold pieces.
He read the paper and instantly got an act.
No, I wrote a bunch of French words.
Vivi.
400, okay.
Un, deux, trois.
And did you... Did you have... Okay, so that is Yume. She's not getting a shield. She's getting that. Check.
So bam, we got devotee sensor. Okay, that's what you want, right?
Devotee sensor.
Okay, devotee sensor. And then we're not getting Yume a shield.
No, that's for Yume. No. Okay. It essentially gives a bunch of HP.
And how much armor?
I would like a plus one or plus two scale mail. I'll take a plus one breastplate or a plus two scale mail.
Yeah,
how expensive is that, Whitey?
Or breastplate. I'm Whitey can tally it up.
Yeah.
So we have DOT sensor and then the armor you're saying for, and then Xander wants armor.
Yes.
And then we just don't know if to get plus one or plus two.
Yeah. Plus
is real
expensive. Yeah. A plus.
That's what I'm going for, scale mail.
Was it a plus one scale mail or plus two what?
He said plus two scale mail or
plus two scale mail or plus one breastplate.
Yeah. Plus one breastplate. A plus two scale mail is going to cost you 550 gold
pieces. Oh, that's not bad at all.
And a plus one breastplate will be 600 gold pieces. 600.
Yeah. I don't care about sneaking around ever. Fuck it. Okay.
And what was Jaden gonna ask for?
Yeah. What did you find?
I wanted to see what other runes he had besides that, and bracers if he happens to have any.
Other what things?
The rune, like the rune of great health that he showed Flint.
The plus 20 health rune.
Oh yeah.
If he had armor. Like any other jewelry stuff that are similar to that.
If you're interested in other trinkets and. Other
items. How much is platinum again?
Platinum is 10 gold. To 1. 10 gold, yeah.
10 gold.
We have 40 platinum.
Hmm. Yeah, my bad.
He goes, we have many a ring if you were interested in something to spice up your hands. We've got ones that give you feather falling. Ones that give you protection. We have some that give you evasion.
Oh.
All the good things.
Hmm. Protection, evasion. Hmm.
One that lets you control animals.
Nah, I already control 7. Let me see the protection and evasion one. You just pull it out on the counter.
Mm-hmm. He pulls out the protection and evasion. The ring evasion is a gold ring with several green emeralds on it and a emerald and like sapphire bird, like a hummingbird that sits on the edge of it.
Oh, this shit looks how much pretty.
Nathan, I'm only missing your gold and that? Silver, platinum. How much did you have exactly? Can you type it?
Exactly. Yeah, you rounded around 600. I think it was exactly like 636 or something. Yeah. 685.
685. But do you have any platinum or silver?
The protection.
No.
Ring of invasion.
I've got 700 copper. Oh.
So we have exactly 2,300 51 gold.
Ring of protection looks interesting.
But if I don't get anything out of it, I'm not giving it to you.
Okay, that's fine.
I'm definitely gonna minus the protection.
I'm gonna minus the 400 off of Yume, so we have 1,951. The armor was what? 500 you said, Whitey? 550?
For which one? The armor?
Scale mail plus
two. Yeah, the scale mail plus two is 550.
Okay. Jaded on.
I'm considering the ring. I'm considering the ring. And how much was that ruin that you mentioned with the plus 20 health? Or was it too expensive?
The armor.
Oh, it was armor? Oh, I thought it was a ruin.
It's an armor with a rune inside.
Oh, fuck. Unfortunate.
It is very powerful.
Unfortunate.
2,000 gold.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we would have been able to afford that if I didn't get robbed.
Okay.
That's the list I have right now.
No, not evasion protection. The evasion one is useless to me.
Oh, ring of protection.
Yeah, the protection one is the one I'm thinking. It's the one I'm going to use.
Then
no pendants?
If you want to see some pendants, we have that too. Or amulets, maybe.
Just show me your two most.
Wait, hold up.
What?
And I think back.
Are you counting the money?
Samuel didn't have armor, right?
Oh, fuck.
No.
But if I find an armor. If I find something to replace mine and give me better protection, I could give him mine.
Yeah, true. So we just.
Wait, does Samuel. Can Samuel use. What is this?
He uses heavy.
Medium. This is medium scale mail.
He uses heavy.
Yeah. It works.
I'm lucky.
Hey, can you? You're proficient in medium and heavy, though? Usually, if you're heavy.
Oh, wait. What? I thought if you were able to use
heavy. No, I think if he's heavy, he can use medium, can't he?
I think you need the exact proficiency.
I got proficiency in heavy, medium, and light, so I'm assuming if you have heavy, it gives you proficiency in all.
Where do you see that?
Bottom left.
On the bottom the left. Very bottom left.
Yeah. It says the thing that I have heavy, is... light, and medium.
Oh, well, there you go. You can use the Mariners.
I was about to say, isn't he a Paladin? I think Paladins just get, like, all of it.
Mm-hmm. Paladins are broken.
Yep, fuck you.
Oh. Damn. <That's about laughs>
Yeah, well, we have 1,401 gold.
Left over, or
leftover?
Currently
left
on
over.
The bill? Oh,
leftover.
Okay. Damn, man, you don't have any bracers, my goodness?
We have some. What brace?
No, but the braces somebody else is using.
Yeah. I am not using them. Xander might be using them, but I'm not sure.
Yeah,
we haven't gotten me armor yet, right?
No. Right now, the only thing we've seen is the plus one, like a plus one light armor for you.
But that puts me at 16. So for that, I just wear the bracers, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
He looks at you and says, "Unfortunately, no bracers.
Unlucky.
We do have a cloak."
Boo. What is the cloak?
What's the cloak do? What's the cloak do?
We just have a cloak.
The cloak of protection. Same as the ring.
Oh, there you go.
It's Doctor Strange's cloak.
If you would want this belt, it's pretty good too.
Ah, you knew where I was going with this.
Mm-hmm. We have the belt of the giant strength.
Ah, the exact one I was looking at. Yeah.
How strong are you feeling?
Oh, that shit would make me pretty strong. I am feeling that.
We can do the hill giant. Gives you a strength of 21.
Yeah.
It's quite powerful.
It would be a plus 4 to strength to me, which is pretty insane.
Can you say the stats on the cloak?
The cloak of protection. Gives you a plus 1 bonus to AC and saving throws.
Same as the ring.
Yeah.
What happened to your French accent?
I pull it out for the customer I need to answer.
You like to make everyone feel at home.
No, shut up. Your mother smells of elderberries.
Oh, there were no berries in my mouth.
Oh. Now, I'll tell you, I had never considered... Changing the cloak, I would much appreciate.
Yeah, yours is pretty smelly already.
I would much appreciate a cloak that's more than just a. I would appreciate a more functional cloak.
So you okay. need, like, the cloak of the...
I think that would be helpful for him, actually. Be really good.
So, devotee sensor, the cloak of protection, the hill giant strength belt. Hang on, I'm saying this so we can like get a total and then see what it is.
Yeah.
So devotee sensor, the cloak of protection, the hill giant belt, the +2 scale mill for Erlen, right?
If we can afford it, I'll go for and +1.
And then Xander's using the bracers.
I suppose I am using the bracers.
Unless we have +2 light armor somewhere in there. Okay, that's so, what I'm saying. So those four things.
If I get the belt, I'm donating the Mariner's armor. Because I have to wear the belt.
No, that's for Sammo regardless. We're going to...
Oh, okay.
So what's the total with those four items right now?
For the ones that you have there listed?
For devotee sensor, cloak of protection, +2 scale mail, and hill giant strength belt.
Let's see.
Or what's the chances I left it on the table of the juggler? Like but I put my cannon, I left the money there too. Yeah.
That'd be funny.
Erlen's thinking.
The total comes out to 1,400 gold pieces.
Really? 1,400?
Right?
Wow. That's a 10% discount?
The scale mail, and devotee was 950.
Why are we arguing? Already.
Yeah, right.
Well, and then the +1 light armor, and then the cloak of protection. Hill giant. Right?
And the, it was the hill giant strength.
Yeah.
Oh, the cloak of protection and the giant strength.
Yeah.
The giant's belt.
Okay, so that puts it to 1,250.
It got cheaper.
Buy one, get one.
Mm-hmm.
The more you buy, the less you buy. More.
What's happening with the path right now? But we bet. Let's do it.
So, yeah. Is there any +2 light armor?
Okay, yeah, we got a lot of money extra, bro.
A +2 light armor. Do you know which one you want?
Speaking out of invisibility.
How much money are you willing to spend?
All of it.
Let me look at the armor in D&D.
You might be best getting a plus. Well, light armor doesn't matter too much, but.
Or a +1 that gives an ability.
Weren't you interested in the shield too, the animated shield?
Yeah, but that was like 1,500 by itself.
Yeah, oh yeah,
that one is very expensive.
I'm getting a message, bro. Necklace of prayer beads. Bro, how much healing you need?
Mm-hmm.
Of what? I'm getting a. What? Pause.
Let me see. Armor.
Bro, on our next week and stuff, as we lead up to the Colosseum, if we win this thing, start finding all the magic items you want, bro. You're going to have infinite wealth. You better. I want these sea princes to get obliterated.
I'm surprised we haven't longer studio, to be honest.
Funny.
I found some symbiotic armor.
I want to know who stole my money.
Literally venom armor.
Venom armor?
While all this is happening, is it possible for me to be like meditating to see if I could fucking think of any instances or any occurrences that could have happened to find out where the fucking money went?
Sure. If you... Yeah.
Let me see if I have anything that aids that.
Mm-hmm. If you have, obviously, like the find object spell, that would be able to do it. Other than that, you can... meditate and think on it harder. I'll give you another chance. Locate object, yeah, that's the one. You could be like, where is his money pouch? And then, it'll tell you. If it's within 1,000 feet or something like that, I think.
I'll tell it. Well, I'll just post it in chat.
Yeah, you would be like, since you're starting, just want
to take concentration up to 10 minutes. Perfect. So it fucking...
Yeah.
If you have the spell, sure, that's that spell cast right there is worth about 1,000 gold or so. I think it was like 800 gold at him.
It's a scorpion armor.
Okay.
Yeah, so you, I can wear the belt.
And that would help you find it if you need it. That, or you can think harder instead of a time where his money could have been stolen.
Okay. Well,
could I wear the belt and the armor together, or is it one or the other?
The belt is its own thing.
Okay. Yeah, thank God.
Well, then we have to buy some all the plus one.
Well, heavy. I'm. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna think about it now because I don't have that spell prepared. And then on the next, like, long rest, I'll prepare it and use it.
Yeah.
Tomorrow we can do all that. Okay.
Yeah, while we're looking for his plus one armor, can we also look at plus one medium armor?
Wait, what?
Because I have literally 16 AC. I need something.
Yeah, but HP is better for you than just armor.
I literally have the lowest HP amongst us.
You have the legendary item, Robe of the Arch Magi?
He goes, oh, we just threw that one away.
Damn.
How much was the 20 HP thing?
That one was about 1,500 gold. But if you're interested in health or a little more life force,
that's why I was asking for the pendants.
I recommend an amulet of health.
Yeah, that's why I was asking for that.
This one is about 400 gold. Increases your constitution 19.
Oh, it's actually really good.
So it's like an extra, whatever your constitution is, like the mod plus that per level.
Health is better.
Oh, no, that definitely helps me out.
It would be an intelligence save, roll, right?
Yeah, if you just want to think on it, it'd be another intelligence roll. Unless you have something else you can think of.
I don't have it prepared. I'm going to do it tomorrow when, like, after I prepare the spell.
Mm-hmm.
So fair I enough. Will guide myself. And roll.
What if you wear?
Nope.
What if Shadow wears a ring of protection?
You can roll it.
You can do. You can get a plus four for your guidance. Maybe get a 16. 14.
Unfortunately, a 14 is not enough.
This guy clouded my gold in fucking darkness.
How much is the ring of protection?
Plus other gold.
The ring of protection. Let me see what that is. A ring of protection is another 400 gold.
As Xander can wear, Shadow can wear ring of protection and the bracers together, and it's plus two AC. It's just they both require attunement.
Which we have time to do, right?
The problem is that better
just,
with
it. It's just two slots for you, so in case you, like, maybe in the future, not now, but in the future, if you get more items that require attunement, you'll have to switch something out. But you could wear the bracers. Because
you could do
ring.
Three slots, but I currently have zero taken, right?
I think so. If you get the bracers and the ring, then that's two slots. And you have plus two AC.
Ooh, wait, the ring of Misty Step? Did I have to attune to that?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, that would be my three slots.
So that's one way you could have plus two AC if you want.
I was trying to look up armors, but like it just gives me the same list of the basic three.
Yeah, I was looking too, and there's like not really that many magical light armors in D&D.
Yes,
like special ones.
Yeah. How about this? Since we're kind of already over the time, and this is probably a good point where you guys can do some research because the Mercate Agency definitely has a lot of magical items available to you.
Yeah, they could get the plane shift ring.
To like the Insult Marsh when you guys started, we can end the session here, give you all some time to do some research, plan your attunements, talk about what you guys want to do for trading magical items, and then start a next session. If you guys like also want to ask me in between now and next session, like, hey, I'm interested in these kind of things, I can do some research and find some stuff and not have to do this all on the fly. So
that would make
be a little better.
That would work.
But sounds great. So to cap off this session, then I'll say we all flash back to Semhale practicing with the Wake's Ruin on the ship.
Something's gonna happen.
What does it look like when you're like trying to attune to this spear and using it around, twirling it, feeling its lightning properties.
So since I'm a
since I have like smite, I already am familiar with lightning. Because I think I explained to you that I wanted my smite to be lightning, right?
Yep.
Or it looked like lightning, at least, yeah. Wait, actually, let me look at it real quick again. Does it have two sides, or is it only one-sided?
It's a one-ended spear.
Okay, yes, yeah. Okay. Yeah, so I kind of envision dancing with it, kind of vaulting as I slash with it or pierce, and then the lightning attack coming, like every slash or anytime it happens, there's a quick flash of lightning.
Alright.
Somewhat thunderous.
Very nice. Do me a favor and roll the weapons attack on your character sheet if you can.
Hang on, a light show on the ship.
Yeah, if you were outside the ship, it kind of looks like a disco is inside. Like, the flashes of light, like the EDM stage.
Yeah. What do you, you want me to roll it from my inventory, right?
Yeah, in the center middle, you should see, the attack now, where it says Ruin's Wake. If you click on that word in the middle of your character sheet.
Yeah, I'm trying to find it. Oh, I see it.
There you go. A 15, not too bad.
And then I can attack twice, right?
So. Yeah, feel free to roll another one.
Cool.
As you are striking this dummy. Not bad. Same thing twice. Crazy.
15, 12, 15, 12. Yeah. Interesting.
Feel free to roll the damage twice as you are striking this dummy with lightning force.
True, so this is four attacks in one, huh?
It's only 2 inches of damage.
You
only
attack twice. Roll the damage. So yeah, click on the word there.
Click the name in the chat box.
I see.
Oh!
Wait, what is going on?
So, are you getting the same stuff? If you click on the Ruin's Wake, in the chat box, click the name Ruin's Wake in the chat box. Yeah.
In the chat box where you...
Yeah, right. That's where I did.
It did?
Wait, on the...
In the actual, right? Logs.
In,
yeah. Yeah, I clicked it under the 1320, the 1512, that's where I clicked it.
It does the same thing? I'll have to look at that. Anyway, it's weird. Because, the number one, I do the same thing, but I'll look and see. But...
Wait, are you saying, under the numbers? Like, where it says 13.8? Yeah.
You should be able to click on, the name Ruin's Wake and, the little purple box.
Yeah, I did. I am.
Interesting. Yeah, okay. I'll have to look at it. I don't wonder why it's doing it for me, but not for you.
Does he obliterate the dummy? Does
it really matter the dummy now? The numbers I rolled, basically what happens, right? You did, 30 damage to it in your one attack action. A lightning bolt strikes it. The dummy is, smoldering.
Dust.
You pierced it in half. And as you do, you hear a voice inside your head say, "Finally, a true champion to wield me."
Wait, what?
That is where we end this session.
None this guy.
Bro, why does my brain get fucked with at all times?
The spear has a voice. Oh, no.
The what has a voice?
The spear. Talk to
Who's ruined?
Bro, I'm about to be a Darkin, bro. Don't worry.
Oh, no.
They take the turn from Paladin. That is where we will end the session. Let me give you guys XP for doing your good old job, and we can wrap it up here, and then you guys can figure out your any time between now and next session the items you're interested in and everything else. We can talk about all that.
Nice.
So what's the cooldown on talking on the genie?
I have no idea.
Do we own a genie now?
8 hours for him to sleep.
I've always that's my warlock patron, so he's the one who gives me my powers.
Oh, I see.
I talk to him sometimes, and sometimes he actually pulls up, sometimes he doesn't.
Yeah. So your cloak has different horses?
And I have him under contract.
Huh? Yeah, it depends on my hands, because I speak through my hands, through sign language. And if my hands get destroyed and I replace them, then I can speak with different voices.
All right. You all will receive 1,500 experience.
Nice.
For doing some shopping for...
How much?
1,500. Signing up for the arena, sneaking through, avoiding any further conflicts, escaping the battle that could have been, and for, you know, having set your plans forward.
So, 41,626. Anybody else there with me?
That's what I have.
Nah, I don't think Whitey has added in my.
I've probably missed yours. You were the same as everyone else, I think.
How much was it, Whitey?
31,363.
41,626.
No, how much did you give us this at now?
1,500.
Yeah.
So I should be at 4,100.
Yeah, I think I put you the same as them. So you should be.
It says 37,026.
Yeah, I've missed a few. Okay. I don't think I've added it to, like, the last few times. I was like, I'll remember to add it later or something.
Yeah, that's where I'm at right now. 37,626.
I was like, yeah, I'll add it. And then we're like, yo, who wants to play League after? He's like, yeah.
Yeah, exactly, right? It's like, I'll do all these things. And then
it's always
gone.
So we'll just put it at like 4,100 or 41,000, sorry.
Yeah, 41,626 should be.
Please make it exact so you're not. 100 off of leveling up, and you're like,
bro. Weird things happen.
Yeah,
it's just it's just easier if everyone levels at the same time. So, trying to keep it pretty consistent at this point.
Okay.
Easier.
I really got robbed.
In broad daylight,
and then nobody knows.
In broad daylight,
to my friends, bro.
You know what? Low key, I'm gonna roll my intelligence to see if I would have known, but I didn't want to roll it.
Let me see. Yeah, because you stole it, bro.
Oh, yeah. Where'd it go, guys? I didn't need the roll.
That's awesome.
I don't think it's high
enough. Oh, shit. Oh, no.
I think we have to get like a 20-something to remember.
I might have seen it.
Yeah, Jadedon thinks back and it's like, wait a minute. It's right here.
Yeah. It's in my pocket.
Funny. No.
I was wondering why my pants are heavy.
I never thought Merlin was the type of guy to get robbed, to be honest.
Dude, in broad daylight,
dude I would
hurts.
Love to see who's bold enough to rob me. I swear to God, bro.
Mm-hmm.
It was Copper.
I will take a life.
Did we put our money down when we went to talk to Ozumata?
I don't know, bro. I
think this is the one session, thing that Whitey. Came to
my head. Yeah, no problem. Hope you have fun.
Thanks for the session, Whitey.
Of Doom!
Of Doom.
Oh, that too.
Bro, that's just...
Oh,
yeah, that should be bonus XP, bro. Yo, make sure you got that list down. What name you got
to
start
I
with.
Have everything written down to the T. I'm not forgetting that one, because...
The amulet that was offered is Amulet of Health, right?
Yeah.
That was the one that was offered to me? Okay.
Wait, what list are we talking about? Right. The items that we're buying?
No,
sure. No. I wanted to know what it was that was offered to me. So I can.
You have everything written down, Wardy?
Items. I've got a lot of stuff written down.
Like the fact that after we win the competition, that the Grand Letician needs to name himself the Grand Letician of Doom.
You know, that's gonna come up. I think if after you guys win, there's gonna be bigger things that are going on that you know he's gonna be less worried about.
If we
but...
win, bro, it's a...
no, I will go and check. All
right, just to make sure I'm doing it right, it's three attuned armor pieces, right?